From Stewart Stadium in Murray, Kentucky, welcome to OVC Football on Fox College Sports. Today, the Tennessee State Tigers take on the Racers of Murray State University. Kevin Ingram with Bob Belvin, glad to have you with us for another week. TSU continues to have an outstanding season at the top of the standings in the Ohio Valley with a 4-1 record. Murray State 2-3, but Bob hoping to spoil things for the Tigers today on their home field.
Well, they would. Tennessee State atop the standings in the Ohio Valley Conference, but it's been a precarious 2 weeks for TSU, barely getting by last week, losing in overtime 2 weeks ago, and they come into Murray State today a little wounded.
And this team under Rod Reed, a one-point win, 22-21 against Tennessee Tech last week at home, and that was a game that saw A.C. Leonard catch the game-winning score, and they kicked the extra point, got out of there with the win, hoping to do the same today.
Well, we've been hoping for A.C. Leonard to come out of his shell, so to speak, for Rod Reed at TSU, and maybe last week was it. He's the big tight end, wears number one. You'll see a lot of him this afternoon.
But their passing defense is going to be put to the test. They've been the best in this conference in pass defense. A little banged up today. Stephen Godbolt might not see him, and that'll be a big factor.
Well, it's going to be a huge factor the way Murray State throws the football. They've named this stadium the track here at Roy Stewart Stadium, and there's a reason why. Murray State will throw the football all over the yard, and you do not want to be depleted in the secondary for Tennessee State.
And for Murray State, boy, we've seen some huge passing games out of Casey Brockman. We'll talk more about him in a little bit, but certainly a dangerous offensive team. Defense has been some of the question this season.
Well, it has been, and they've got to step up this afternoon if Murray State wants to win this football game and stop that small passing game, if you will, of Tennessee State, because Tennessee State likes to run the football as well.
Yeah, the rushing attack is outstanding. Let's talk about a couple players we'll see today. Certainly for Tennessee State, Travis Ward's had a great season, over 1,200 yards rushing, 14 touchdowns on the ground, averaging close to 5 yards per carry.
Travis Ward has been rock solid for Tennessee State, and I feel like sometimes when they've gotten in slumps offensively, they've run him back to back to back, and he's been successful and kind of jump-started that offense.
And getting good decisions out of Mike German, another key for TSU, because they have certainly some good targets in their own right.
Well, German is a run threat pass option as well, and that's a big part of TSU's offense. So getting him to the edge and giving him that freedom to run or throw is something Murray State must contain this afternoon.
We saw three of the four Peyton Award watch list members in the game we did last week. We'll see the other one today in Casey Brockman. Just an amazing season.
Well, these are game type numbers or video game type numbers for Murray State. And of course, Brockman, the local guy from Murray High School, has a chance to play on the big stage here at Murray State, and he is one of the nation's leaders in passing.
Off the top, we talked about the logjam at the top. TSU has to win to stay in front in this league.
Yeah, and again, they're just hanging on in their last few games. They need a big road win today. Then they've got a strange bye week, and then they'll finish out the season, but this will go a long way to OVC, or rather the OVC championship for TSU.
We'll have the kickoff for you in just a moment. Tennessee State, Murray State coming up on Fox College Sports. And welcome back. Stewart Stadium, Murray, Kentucky, getting ready for OVC football on Fox College Sports. I'm Bob Belvin. I'm Kevin Ingram. Glad to have you with us. Murray State hosting Tennessee State. The Tigers 4-1 in Ohio Valley Conference play, right at the top of the standings. UT Martin, Eastern Illinois, also with 4-1 records. For Murray State, a 2-3 conference mark. Racers won the toss deferred, so it will be Tennessee State to get the football first. Chris Hatcher, his second season here in Murray. Actually, his third year with a 16-14 record. Overall, 110-41. Stops at Georgia Southern and Valdosta State along the way. Opposite sideline, we'll see Rod Reed in his third year as well. 16-15, his record at Tennessee State. Guy who was an outstanding player for the Tigers. Defensive coordinator, played back in the 80s. So it should be a fun matchup as Murray State will kick things off. It'll be Jordan Benton to send it away in just a moment. There's Rod Reed, his third year. And Bob, we saw the intensity of Coach Reed a couple weeks ago in that tough overtime loss for the Tigers down at Jacksonville State.
Yeah, we did a couple of bad penalties. All penalties are bad, but the timing of them were very unfortunate for Tennessee State, which led to that Griffin Thomas field goal in overtime, which defeated TSU. They had a chance to win it in regulation, and TSU was called for offsides.
Travis James, Weldon Garlington. To return, it will be James from his 11 as we get started. And knocked out at the 20, so decent field position for TSU. As they'll bring on the offense, led by redshirt sophomore quarterback Michael German, number 12. 6'3", 220 out of Pompano Beach, Florida. 2,100 yards passing and 13 touchdowns in the season. 7 interceptions, 60% completion rating, or completion percentage, I should say. Scored a TD rushing as well. 294 through the air last week on 24 of 40. But, Bob, the big one in that game was a touchdown at the end to A.C. Leonard, the sophomore out of Jacksonville, a Florida transfer, and a guy who's become, as you talked about in the open, more of a featured part of this offense as they've gone along this season.
Well, sometimes it takes quarterbacks, in German's case, a long time to develop that relationship with transfers, but also from the standpoint of finding the tight end, not always looking for the deep ball, finding the tight end as a safety valve. And that's exactly what he did last week for the game-winning touchdown. Looks like we're going to actually did have a penalty against Murray State, and we're going to re-kick this one. So we'll have a chance to set it again as you get a good look at Chris Hatcher and what a job he has done here at Murray State. They call it the Hatch Attack. They renamed, if you will, to some degree, Roy Stewart Stadium. It still bears Roy Stewart's name, but they call this facility the Track. And that speaks to the kind of offensive philosophy that Chris Hatcher has brought here to Murray State. And he's got the perfect quarterback to implement that in Casey Brockman.
We'll see him in just a little bit. Offside, I assume, on the kickoff. So they'll try it again as they'll put the football down.
Take a look at Hatcher and you think about how fortunate are you to bring that type of offense to Murray. And then you get to recruit a quarterback from Murray High School to come and run your offense for you. And by the way, he's a great quarterback in Casey Brockman. So all of those ingredients kind of came into the mix at just the right time for Murray State and Chris Hatcher's arrival.
Another Murray native, Jordan Benton, will try it again. Apparently no penalty, just some mix up on the kickoff, and try one more time to get this thing underway. Garlington this time drifting back inside the five. Here comes a flag and down at the 19-yard line.
Number 23, Darian Skinner on the tackle, but we do have a flag on the play.
And the guilty party is going to be Tennessee State for a block in the back as Garlington turned it up the middle of the field. So what was okay starting field position will not be this way for Tennessee State.
Today's referee, Todd Dunaway. Well, penalties were a big part of last week's story for TSU, and that's something that Coach Rodriguez has not been happy with, especially in the red zone. False starts, saying it kind of put them behind schedule. You go from first and 10 to first and 15. Your play calling changes and all those things, but they've had some issues in terms of penalties, and you know, we talked about it that game in Jacksonville State a couple weeks ago.
They're averaging 89 yards a game in penalties, and that's enough to offset any high explosive offense. They've really got to cut down on that.
So starting from the 7, first play from scrimmage in this afternoon's game, or this morning as the case may be. Completion out to James past the 15. And have enough for a first down to the 18-yard line.
And while we talked a lot about A.C. Leonard, James is the primary target for German coming into this game. Leonard has just kind of come on, as we mentioned, and been kind of supplemental and a big part of supplemental right then. But nice catch by James, and then move the chains early.
This TSU offense, an outstanding line up front, especially the left side, Gaines, Edwards, and Carter. They average 313 up front. A.C. Leonard, we mentioned him, 8 catches for 102 last week and a touchdown. Top 3 in the FCS among tight ends in receptions and in yards. First and 10, opening minute. James in motion. Play fake to Ward. German looks, sends it downfield, and incomplete. Trying to find Devin Wilson on the other side of midfield. Good coverage for the Racers.
For number 11, Devin Wilson is
well, early on, trying to stretch that defense with the deep ball. Josh Manning on the coverage, transfer out of LaGrange, Georgia. And right then, German showing a lot of arm, Kevin, throwing the deep ball initially, trying to, again, stretch that defense after throwing the medium ball earlier to James to get the first down.
Coach Hatcher saying about this defense, maybe played his best football against Jacksonville State last week. And you know, talking about the improvement of defenses, not only his own, but those around this league, saying just get a little better as the season goes along, more reps, a little more familiar with maybe what they're doing and some of the other teams. First carry of the day for Travis Ward. Been as busy as any running back in FCS.
And very successful at that. He's got a bunch of 100-yard games already this season, and we've had the luxury of seeing Ward early on, but he has been a big part of getting the run game going for Tennessee State. They've got a few others they'll bring off the bench to bring in and supplement him.
No gain on that carry. Third down and 10. Murray State defense. 4-3 look. Heavy on juniors. Seven of them in the starting 11. Averaging 263 up front. From the gun here on third down, it's German. Over the head of Leonard. And incomplete. TSU will be forced to punt. Things just not really coming together in that first drive for the Tigers.
Well, no. In that case, Leonard was open, Kevin. Just a high throw then by German. He had gotten beyond the linebackers and got into that secondary and had a first down and went right to the marker opposite side of the field. But the high pass by German, not so much. And, of course, the overthrow on the long ball down the middle as well. So not a great start for German throwing the football.
German Godfrey on to punt.
Number nine,
averaging 35 yards per punt, and Murray's going to get good field position out of this with the return men standing around midfield. Back to the 41, and well covered as Walter Powell tried a short return, and it'll be the 45-yard line for the Racers to get started.
Godfrey coming off a Player of the Week performance, Specialist of the Week performance here for the Ohio Valley Conference.
Take a timeout. Murray gets the football. We'll get a first look at Casey Brockman when we come back. OBC football on Fox College Sports.
Hey, it's Vince.
Three and out for TSU in its opening drive. Murray State will get a chance now with senior quarterback Casey Brockman at the controls. Two wides right and one left. First play from scrimmage. Fake and a handoff. Nice run for a first down into TSU territory as he handed it to Jamal Berry, the junior out of Miami. Ohio State transfer. Two-time OBC newcomer of the week this year.
And he's carried
now 19 times, actually 66 times, I should say. He has 18 receptions. Five total touchdowns on the year. Quickly a first down play with a pass, and it'll be a short gain inside the 40 for this Racer offense.
When we talked, Powell was one of his top targets. Not the case that time for Brockman. Again, somewhat like EIU, just sitting that little bit of zone in front of the linebackers. We saw against EIU last week, very up tempo. I got to be on my game, Kevin.
No, yeah, you got to. Both got to pay attention here. Second and five. Brockman over the middle, incomplete.
Off the umpire's shoulder. Now we're going to have a penalty flag come in very late. I thought that ball glanced off the umpire's shoulder.
Like Andrew Taylor on the coverage, free safety for TSU. Get the call here in just a moment.
Holy on the defense, number 21, 10-yard penalty, foul.
Taylor, the guilty party. Now, we talked about the changes going on in the Tennessee State secondary. You know, obviously that's easily identified by the coaching staff of Murray State. And we're looking to make sure Godbold is on the field. We're way up high and loving it, but this does require some binoculars.
Here's a handoff as they will give to Berry one more time and moving the football effectively down to the 15. Talked about Stephen Godbold, the concussion in that game last week for the sophomore out of Cross City, Florida, has begun cover corner, and they've had to move some folks around in the secondary.
Great example of how important the run game is for people like Casey Brockman that can throw the ball.
And now it's going to be a penalty that time on David Van Dyke. I think it's going to be play out of bounds.
But it does bring a flag on the play.
Jordan Morrow with the reception. Junior H-back at Fairfield, California.
Number 28 on the defense. Coming half the distance from the end of the run. First half.
So a good chance for an early score here for Murray State after the penalty down to the 7.
Six-yard line where it'll be first and goal.
Tennessee State go with a heavy package up front. Hard to not look for the pass in this situation, knowing Murray State's history.
They'll trick it up a little bit, and an interception. That play made by Ronnie Vincent. First pick of the year. They mixed it up a little. I think that was Josh Brown throwing the pass.
It was, Kevin. And sometimes, you know, you just outthink yourself from a coaching perspective. And that goes back to what I talked about before that play went down, and that was with Brockman throwing the football, your success with it. You've got a lot of options right then, but you had a first and goal inside the 10.
He had four shots. I'm not so sure the trick play is what you want to be looking at right then when your offense has been so powerful. They had a stretch, Murray State did, where they scored 140 points in three games.
So they try to roll the dice a little and throw a pick. TSU getting the football at the 20. Some movement, it looked like, before the play began, and an incompletion at the 45, penalty on that end as well. A flag back at the 20 and one at the 45 of Murray.
So we've got a lot to sort out here, but what we do know is that German, this time going down the left sideline, trying to throw that pass to his favorite receiver. But before that, I think we had it offsides against Murray State.
Yeah, it was basically a free play for TSU. Play continued.
Number 90 on the defense. That penalty is declined. Pass interference. Number 4 on the defense. That penalty is 15 yards from the previous punt. First down.
So Josh Manning called for the interference. TSU will take that one. Get the ball at the 35.
And there's the free play you talked about, Kevin. Just throw it deep down the left sideline. Travis Chains. First down, Tennessee State.
High formation for the Tigers here, early minutes of this game. Murray with an excellent chance to score through a pick. Now Michael German, his second attempt with this TSU offense, hands this time to Travis Ward
on the carry.
Get two or three to the 38. What a year the redshirt junior from Dillard High School in Fort Lauderdale is having. 12:05, 14 touchdowns coming in, 133 yards rushing per game.
Second down and eight.
Just had some monster games on the ground this season. Second and eight. Ward again, looking for the edge. Good blocking, and we'll set up a third and short.
That is Ward on a carry.
Looks like it's going to be a penalty on the offensive line there, Tennessee State. Just coming back down and trying to make that block. It's going to be the right tackle. Not quite sure where they're going to get Brandon Haskin. Kevin Kenton on that call. Now they picked up the flag. It's a pretty good lobbying effort right then by Tennessee State.
Gonna make it third and two.
Gonna bring up third down and two on the Tennessee State 43-yard line.
Now 4 minutes deep here. TSU trying to convert on third down. On the season, 44%. Oh for one today. Ward trying to shake free, will have enough as he pushes toward midfield. Move the chains for the Tigers.
Just got out of the grasp of the tackle of Tyler Evans, a big defensive tackle out of Tampa, Florida, trying to get his fellow Floridian Travis James, but or Travis Ward rather, but not enough, and Ward able to get that first down by a hair.
James to the top of your screen. Wilson to the right as German looks to the sideline. 46-yard line here for the Tigers. Quickly outside, James gets to midfield for TSU. Bob, this is really more what TSU likes to do right here, more sustained drives. Murray State, you know, they want to march it down, see how many plays they can run, and take advantage of that situation.
Take a look at James here. He's just going to come back to the football, just a quick pass as they check back to the line, and then they'll make this throw to him, and he'll just squeak forward for about a 4 or 5 yard gain. And now they're going to check off yet again, and that's going to be the commonplace situation you're going to see for Tennessee State most of the afternoon. They'll come to the line, check it off.
German under center, tries a slant incomplete. The time trying to go to Joe Bowens. Saw him make a couple catches in the game, did a couple weeks ago. 18 receptions for 232 on the year.
Good look there at Daryl Smith, the transfer from Arkansas defensively right then. Home crowd liked it. TSU crowd thought it might be a little too early there on the contact.
Second and six from right at midfield for TSU. Double tight end set. Underneath. Dropped off to Leonard. First down and more. Upended inside the 30. Good catch and run by A.C. Leonard. Florida transfer, the sophomore, made the game-winning catch last week.
That big number one is coming on as the season progresses. This was a play by design, and you have to have the blocking, and that's what German got in that situation. Yeah, he got pressure, and that pocket started to collapse, but then your tight end just comes off the formation right in the middle of the field where it had cleared out for him. You'll see right here, nobody around him. He's got a lot of running room and gets many yards after the catch.
So Blake Salter in there, the linebacker, trying to make the play. First and 10, 27-yard line for TSU. Here's Ward. Cuts it back in instead of following his fullback out into the 25. Thought might be a little skirmish on the ground, but just a little slow getting untangled. But well, really... Sorry, by the really nice left side of the offensive line for TSU we talked about.
And one of the best names in the conference, T. Ray Ballone, a linebacker out of Tennessee with a tackle for Murray State right there. A shoestring tackle, I might add.
He's a very good player for the Smyrna Bulldogs. And outside, they got it to Bowens, and he'll have a first down at the 15.
Well, you've seen all the targets so far for Tennessee State. You see Ward running the football, Bowens, Leonard, James, and this is just a wide receiver screen. Real quick, get him the football, see what he can do.
Another first down for TSU. Here's a run for Ward. Picks his way through and got it to the 10, a five-yard pickup.
Tennessee State very happy. 5 yards at a chunk, the screen pass to the wide receiver, whatever it takes to get those sustained drives that you talked about, Kevin. That's going to be the contrast in this game. Obviously, TSU would prefer to eat a lot of clock up and take the ball out of Casey Brockman's hands. This type of drive is exactly what they want to do throughout the game.
Near the midpoint in this opening quarter, TSU, time of possession per game over 31 minutes. Second and 5. Ward dragged down from behind, close to another first down. That was Adrian Dinkins, defensive end out of Ridgeland, Mississippi, on the stop.
But again, big chunks of yardage. This one's just going to go off left tackle. Travis Ward will get the call here. Now it's a first and goal situation for Tennessee State.
Well, we saw Murray turn the football over in this situation on the other end of the field. Now TSU with an opportunity from the 5. Jumbo package here. Ward will pound it down to the 2.
Well, you just like the way Travis Ward runs. And as you mentioned, he has that big offensive line. Coached by Russ Urnfeld, who's been in this league a long time. And it's nothing fancy. It's just down-your-throat football. You're going to see more of it here.
They'll try it again from the 2. Ward bounces off, looking for the goal line. He got there. 2-yard carry for Travis Ward. Good second effort to put TSU on the scoreboard first.
A 2-yard touchdown run by number 2, Travis Ward.
So the last few yards, Travis Ward, but that series... Nearly all Travis Ward, 30 yards alone on the ground in that series for Tennessee State. So they turn the turnover into points, and that's what you like to do on the road. And that's why they sit atop this OVC race.
Here's Godfrey for the point after attempt. Knocks it through to make it 7-0 TSU. A little under 7 minutes to play. First quarter, Tigers strike first here in Murray. Get a look on the way out. The touchdown carry for Travis Ward bounces off and finds the goal line. OVC football on Fox College Sports.
Imagine you're in 207996.
A 12-play, 80-yard drive over 5 minutes elapsed as TSU has the first points of today's game, 7-0 over Murray State on a 2-yard run by Travis Ward, who's already carried 9 times for 28 yards, and that touchdown, which for him this season rushing was number 15 on the year. This continues to have a monster junior season. Tigers will kick it off. Get another look at Casey Brockman in the Murray attack. What a return is Buford. 25, nicely done to the 35. H.B. Buford, only a second return of the season.
It'll be first and 10, Murray State.
Set things up for the offense for the Racers.
Not necessarily concerned about the offensive strategy for Murray State, but what I will make a note as we watch his kickoff return is I think you're going to see a little bit of a back-to-basics approach. Let's don't get fancy like we did down in the red zone, and let's go ahead and do what we do well, and that's let Casey Brockman throw the ball out of the yard and then mix in that running game, which is really improving now for Murray State.
Pair of wides each way. Brockman time to throw over the middle and incomplete, trying to go to Patrick Robertson. The senior
for number five, Patrick Robertson,
has 28 catches for 216 and a score on the season from Carrollton, Texas.
And right near him was a leading tackler for Tennessee State. That's Nick Thrasher. We haven't talked a lot about him yet. He's 42. You're going to want to watch him. He is an outstanding linebacker, one of the outstanding linebackers in this league.
A very young TSU defense, 90 tackles on the season. Second and 10. They will run Brady. Cross midfield and through the 42.
Tackle made by number 28, David Van Dyke.
David Van Dyke.
That gain is good enough for another Racer.
40 tackles after that stop for the free safety.
First and 10, Murray State.
Murray State again moving it effectively. Ball at the 42. Saw him stall out with a pick in the end zone. Had a first and goal in the first series. Brockman underneath. This is Trotter, and another first down.
That's a nice job by Trotter, just getting into that open area in the middle. Had a pretty good pick there by his fellow wide receiver. Didn't catch a number, but he was wide open. And now Tennessee State trying to make these personnel changes. A little difficult in this up-tempo.
Well, that's what makes it tough. You know, we saw the same thing, Bob, out of Eastern Illinois last week, making it difficult for Eastern Kentucky to change personnel when they needed to or get some fresh troops up front. Brockman will hand, another big hole. Brady to the 12, move the chains again.
And Rashad Knight's going to leave the game, and he's a little shaken up defensively for Tennessee State. He was the one that had the initial hit on Brady, but unable to wrap him up. So now Murray State right back in the red zone again.
Brockman from the gun, shoots it right side, pass complete. Did he get there? It's Powell. It is. A touchdown from 13 yards. Nice play by Powell to find the pylon.
Now, this is a nice job on the outside. He got a screen from the wide receiver, his fellow wide receiver out there, and came back down the line of scrimmage. Nicely designed play, and then the last 5 to 7 yards all on his own for the touchdown.
Seventh touchdown reception of the season for Powell from St. Louis. Talk about the number of terrific games he's strung together. Four of over 100 yards receiving. Extra point to tie this ball game. On the money for Benton.
Tennessee State 7.
Just under 6 minutes to play in this first quarter. Expected offense, we've seen it so far, 7 apiece. Watch this. Daniel Fitzpatrick with the initial hit, couldn't finish. Stewart Stadium, Murray, Kentucky. One of the things you'll see throughout today when Murray scores, Racer 1 taking a lap. They've had plenty of opportunity to give the horse the thoroughbred a workout this season with this offense and Casey Brockman.
Yeah, big-time scoring offense. And, again, back to the first turnover they committed inside the red zone, took it down the field, and I thought got a little too cute in that situation. Tried the halfback pass. It was intercepted. Tennessee State takes it back down the field to score. But you can see just early on this high-octane Murray State offense. They do not huddle. It's not as higher tempo as we saw last week against Eastern Illinois, but they will get off a number of snaps, probably in the 70s by the time this game is over.
Took less than a minute, 5 plays, 65 yards, and a very nice effort by Walter Powell to get to the end zone. Stevenson takes it out to the 22. Good coverage from Murray State. 5:49 opening quarter, 7 apiece, TSU and Murray. 2-yard run by Travis Ward on the last series for Tennessee State. shaken up player for the Racers. Looks like everybody's okay. Those Pokey Harris on the coverage, a freshman. He'll jog off on his own power, and we'll see the offense for Tennessee State back on.
Kevin, I think this is the point of the game where you begin to see those adjustments defensively that both teams must make, because it looks like we may have a shootout on our hands here. So what do you do this early in the game to adjust defensively to try and take that other team out of their offensive rhythm?
Talk about some of the scores from the other Murray games this season. They have had some shootout games. TSU likes to play things a little more down in the 20s, and it's certainly worked for them with 8 wins this year. Ward on first down will carry for a yard or so.
On the carry.
Wrapped up by
tackle made by number 92, Jeremy Brackett.
Jeremy.
No gain on the play. Bring up second
Brackett,
down and 10.
Defensive tackle.
Well, in their last 4 games, Murray State has scored 70, 52, 59, and 35.
Problem is, on some of those, they've given up some big numbers as well, you know?
Right. It's out of that game they won 70-35, 152-14, but lost to Tennessee Martin, and that's the game that they look back to in their homecoming loss, 66-59 here 3 weeks ago.
Another carry for Ward, only got a yard or two. They bring up 3rd and 9.
Bring up 3rd down and 8.
Call it 3rd and 8. Ball to 24.
This is the perfect situation for A.C. Leonard, the tight end. So let's keep an eye on where he's going to line up at. And they're going to keep him in the inside slot. And they will not press cover Leonard.
See him to the right of the formation. And German to throw over the middle, incomplete. Looking for Leonard more to the left side, couldn't find him.
That'll bring up 4th down.
That's all about the pressure that German got right then, because he had Leonard open coming across the formation. He might put that one in their back pocket and come back to it.
So it's been 2-3 and outs and a long drive for a touchdown for Tennessee State on his first 3 series of this game.
Number 43, Jamin Godfrey, back deep for the Racers. Number 9, Walter Powell.
Seeing a tight end like Leonard probably reminds you of mornings in your morning show you spend with a tight end who likes to. He would like A.C. Leonard. That would be Frank Wycheck. Yeah. He would certainly like a guy like A.C. Leonard and what he does.
It'll be 1st and 10.
Walter Powell on the return. Murray State will get it at the 42. Tie ball game at 7. We'll go to a break. Tennessee State, Murray State, OBC football on Fox College Sports.
If you suffer with low back pain, you know there hasn't been an easy answer to treat the kind of discomfort you feel on a daily basis. Until now. Introducing Low Back Tracks. Low Back Tracks is a new FDA-cleared device that's revolutionizing the treatment of lower back pain.
7 apiece. Murray State, the home team. Tennessee State, the visitors for the 3rd year in a row, and kind of a scheduling quirk in this series. We resume play from Stewart Stadium, late 1st quarter, 4:22 to go. Saw the offense for Murray do what it does best on the last series, a long touchdown drive in less than a minute. Rockman plenty of time. Found the open man, Griffin, middle of the field for a 1st down, and right away inside TSU territory to the 42.
That completion is good enough.
Tennessee State rushing 3 in that situation, and on the coverage, Daniel Fitzpatrick, but didn't look to have a chance right then on that crossing route across the middle.
TSU trying to guard the receivers, 3-man front. Brockman, good coverage for TSU, and that one's incomplete.
Pass intended for number 22, Jordan Morrow, is incomplete.
Jordan Morrow.
That'll bring up 2nd down. And
caught
10.
A pass earlier, but incomplete right there. So 2nd and 10.
Well, again, TSU only rushing 3. 5 offensive linemen there. So, again, Brockman's got a lot of time. Now that leans on the receivers to run very good routes and find a way to get open.
Saw Barksdale creep up for a moment. See if we get a flag. Yes is the answer.
For number 9, Walter Powell is incomplete.
Powell was the intended receiver.
Burnell Brooks, yeah. It's going to be the guilty party. And Brooks is one of those that has been moved around in the secondary as a result of Stephen Godbolt not playing this afternoon with a concussion.
Yeah, we mentioned Godbolt's injury.
Pass interference.
on the defense. Number 24, 15-yard penalty from the previous spot.
And the concussion and Godbolt being out of the lineup meant Vincent moves to the other side. Brooks switches to the right
Penalty
corner.
The ball to the
look one more time.
It's Patrick will get that right arm in and kind of pull the intended receiver to the ground. That's pretty easy. He's having a lot of troubles out there, so they may shift some coverage over, try and help Brooks out a little bit.
The SU will rush four here. And Murray will run the football. Berry with the tote.
Jamal Berry.
2 yard gain to the 25. Something we've seen, Bob, in these opening minutes. Murray be able to run the football pretty effectively. And you talk about the game last year, TSU really kind of loaded up to stop the run, and they burned him for 600 yards. Brockman did, 7 touchdowns. Even caught one in that game. Pressured here. Now directs traffic with Barksdale back there, and a completion to the 14.
You know, wave it off and say no, just out of bounds. Boy, what a job. Herculean effort then by Brockman to avoid the sack, buy himself some more time. And then it was kind of a stop-start situation because I think his receivers, many of which were on deeper routes into the end zone, felt he was going to be sacked and kind of stopped and then had to reestablish their route and try and come back and help him. But those numbers speak for themselves, or that titling right there speaks for itself. We'll talk more about that.
Third and 8, Brockman. Found Berry out of the backfield to the 19.
Now Thrasher comes up on Berry and puts good coverage on him for that linebacker position, Kevin. But Berry still finds a way to get himself open for his quarterback. That's a very underrated yet good play then by Jamal Berry.
Fourth and 2, Murray going to go for it. Brockman will tuck it and run. I don't know if he's going to have enough or not. We'll have to wait for the spot. Going to be close. Had to get to the 17 for the first down.
Got one of those right foot, left foot spots here.
That was the 22nd time this year Murray's gone for it, or 13 of 21 before that try.
Take a look, Brockman. Nothing fancy here. Going to show pass a little bit, but going to just run it right there at left tackle, left guard, and it will indeed be enough for a first down. So probably coming to the game, you told me, Casey, Brockman would rush for a first down here in the first quarter. I might have been a little suspicious.
Well, he had to get to the 17 and got it just passed and closer to the 16. Drive continues for Murray State. And here's Berry trying to find some room. Maybe a little too much shake and bake, and Antonio Harper found him. Progress to the 15 to be a gain of about a yard and a half.
And Harper would have them into that coming in from that left end position.
He's a good one. Last year's second team all OVC. Quickly to the line for another play.
Wayne Brady on the carry.
Brady gets the call.
Tackle made by number 55, Anthony Bass.
Not a lot of messing around.
Bring up third down.
Here's Brady again.
Wayne Brady on
so
the carry.
So three straight running plays out of a quicker tempo offense. Left. Still not huddling, but the play calling is happening quicker. Now a big
fourth down and 2 for the Racers.
Another fourth down situation that are going to kick here. He's somewhere in the neighborhood of a 25-yard attempt for Jordan Benton. 8 of 11 on field goal tries this year, well within his range with a long of 39.
For the Racers.
Played for Campbellsville before transferring to Murray. From 25 to put Murray in front for the first time.
And it's good.
It bends good.
Murray takes 10.
10-7. Racers in front for the first time. Timeout on the field. 3-point lead for Murray. TSU gets the football in a moment. OVC football on Fox College Sports. plays, 50 yards, 3:05 on the scoring drive for Murray State, leading for the first time today, 10-7 over TSU, a Jordan Benton 25-yard field goal. Casey Brockman, we keep an eye on his numbers, 6 of 9, 57 yards, and a touchdown pass earlier to Powell.
So a little more running game in this sequence for Murray State, especially those three rushes inside the red zone would set up the field goal. And Murray State, as you mentioned, takes the lead. So they've been pretty impressive offensively here this first quarter, with the exception of maybe getting a little too cute with that halfback pass, which cost them another possession inside the red zone.
Weldon Garlington and Martine Stevenson will return for TSU as get the kickoff in a moment. TSU just an outstanding season, 8-1 overall, 4-1 in the OVC, only defeat a couple weeks back at Jacksonville State in overtime, 31-28. Game they thought they might have won, but for a penalty. Now returnable from the four. This is Stevenson. Shut down at around the 20 as the Tigers will start this series.
Number 22, Jordan Morrow on the tackle for the Racers. It'll be first and 10, Tennessee State.
The first time this afternoon, Tennessee State will be playing from behind, although just 3 points. But when we've seen Travis Ward run the football the way he has, and certainly a little bit of passing mixed in, and a couple of misses actually on German throws, especially the A.C. Leonard, Tennessee State has to feel good about where they are in terms of settling in offensively and providing that balance, I think, is important for them against this 4-3 defense.
Sherman off to a 4-of-8 start. Throw here on first down. Leonard, the ball a little bit behind him, couldn't make the catch at the 25.
Pass intended for number one, A.C. Leonard is incomplete. That'll bring up second
down. We talked
down
about some of the numbers on Leonard. Third among FCS tight ends in reception. Second in yardage for tight ends. 37 catches for 528, 4 scores on the season. Florida transfer who last year had a big game against Florida State. Scored a touchdown. Go back to the featured back Ward, and he'll be pushed back this time. T. Ray Malone, we talked about him earlier out of Smyrna, Tennessee. Stop for a loss.
Malone just fills the gap here as the guard and tackle come out to the outside to block for Ward, and Malone just sensed that's where Ward was going and met him right at the line of scrimmage. So third and long again for Tennessee State, and we've seen this a couple of times early on. Been able to convert and keep drives alive. They need to do so here.
Well, stopping Ward and talking to, or hearing the comments anyway, of head coach Chris Hatcher from Murray State, said that was job one for his defense. I think that's the case every week when you play Tennessee State. Third and nine. Rolling to throw German. Pressure arrives and he throws it away. Good job by Murray to bring the heat. And really a good job by German to not really try to do too much right there and just send it out of bounds.
I would add not turn the football over. Watch the pursuit coming here from Tyler Evans. And he causes that ball to be thrown out of bounds in a very hurried fashion by German. And again, good move as he brought the ball up to throw it. Evans trying to bear down on him and knock it loose. And that's the smartest thing Michael German could have done in that situation.
Allen Davis to return. Murray's going to get good field position again as we're in the closing seconds of this first quarter. Powell thought about trying to make an over-the-shoulder catch, let it drop instead, and 35-yard line is where the Racers will start this series. They lead it 10-7. Touchdown and a field goal after TSU struck first on a 2-yard run by Travis Ward earlier.
We do have a flag on the play.
Kind of a marker on the play way back at the 17. A call from our referee, Todd Dunaway, in a moment.
Illegal formation, 5 minutes max fill on the kicking tee, 5-yard penalty assessed at the end of the kick.
So this will mean Murray will get it at the 40-yard line to begin this series.
Penalty moves the ball to the Racer 40-yard line. Will
started to say with
9
seconds left, Bob, they'd have time for one play to finish up the first quarter, but the way the these offenses run, never know.
Brockman a little behind schedule. compared to some other games, and by that 47 yards passing here in the first quarter, that's, you know, you average that at over four. Well, that's not quite where he's been so far this season.
Throws on first down, right on cue to near midfield on the completion.
Walter Powell,
favorite target. As the first quarter reaches its conclusion, we've seen some offense. Murray State in front 10-7 after 15 minutes of football here in Murray, Kentucky. We'll take a timeout. Not too far to go to the other side of midfield as the Racers will continue in just a moment. OVC football on Fox College Sports. Well, if you can't see your favorite OVC football or basketball team on TV, check out the OVC Digital Network to see all the non-televised Ohio Valley Conference football and basketball home contests for free. Don't miss out on any of the action. Log on to OVCDigitalNetwork.com. Murray State will log on with a second and one to start the second quarter. And a carry by Casey Brockman, the quarterback. Seen that a couple times today to convert for the first down.
Had Brockman converting on fourth down earlier, and this time with the carry on third down, and that just gives him a new set of downs and a new opportunity for him to throw the football.
Not much time between plays. Brockman in that first quarter, 7 of 10 for 66 yards and a score. One of the Walter Payton Award watch list members, four of them in this conference, saw three last week. Good coverage by TSU, but making himself available for the reception was number 17, Dontell Watkins, first time called his name today. From Nashville, a Utah State transfer into Murray, the X receiver position, the senior.
And making himself available is a great estimation and great observation of what went on right then. Brockman in trouble, comes back to the football, helps his quarterback out.
36 for Murray, complete to the outside. Boy, I thought Morrow was out of bounds, and he was right near the 30-yard line.
Now Brockman over 80 yards throwing. Now he's picked up that that pace a little bit.
Well, he's got a long way to go to get to the 600 he had in this game last year. We'll give this time. Nicely done as Barry was hit before he could find the hole. That was Antonio Harper coming up.
In case you're wondering, Kevin did not stutter. Casey Brockman threw for 600 yards in this game last season. And take a look at this formation down on the far side of the field.
Well, diamond set to this near side here. Four receivers, but they go to the opposite side. Another completion made to Watkins, but couldn't get a whole lot. Mac may have lost a yard or two.
And Wilson Robinson with a stop, and one of the elements of that diamond formation we just looked at was to bring the defense to that side of the field and give Watkins a one-on-one opportunity. Just was not able to shake the tackle, so now a big fourth down for Murray State.
They went for it once and made it on the last series. A little more yardage to get here, though. Saw Brockman carry on a fourth and short. Looks to the sideline. And now Murray's going to take a timeout.
Timeout.
We'll take it with him. A couple minutes in, second quarter, 10-7. Murray State leading Tennessee State. OVC football on Fox College Sports.
You don't become a legend by being distracted. Legends are born out of discipline and focus. We are Legends Bank. Committed, strong, growing stronger. Be part of something legendary. Legends Bank. Member FDIC.
Murray State has a rich history of traditions that link generations of students. We provide a unique living atmosphere that offers academic guidance, social functions, and recreational facilities. Murray attracts students who are seeking a great education in a personalized college town setting. There are so many reasons to attend Murray State University. See them at exploremurraystate.com. Murray State University, your world to explore.
College football every Saturday on Fox.
Do you know what it means to have someone's back? To have another life depend on you and only you?
Where your vision, your defense, your support
is the very...
Leading 10-7, Murray State using a timeout before a 4th-and-6 attempt. See the time there. Just over 13 minutes to play in this first half. Pistol formation for Casey Brockman and the Racer offense. Top passing attack in the league against the top pass defense, but a little shorthanded today. Incomplete going to Powell. TSU gets a hold. Nice coverage by Brunell Brooks.
Well, Powell's your favorite target if you're Brockman, but just didn't get enough zip on that football to the outside. And, of course, Powell probably getting a little more attention in that situation. So Brunell Brooks, the starter, we'll call him the emergency starter, but the unanticipated starter, say, midweek, makes a good defensive play right then on a pass. Again, I thought Brockman could have thrown with a little more zip on it. So, again, turning the ball over on downs and then the turnover earlier. And now Murray State has given up relatively good field position to Tennessee State.
TSU ball at its own 32 to start this series. In the top of the standings in this conference all season long. And here's Travis Ward. Big reason why. He'll spin forward for a gain of 6. Out to the 38.
Tennessee State ranked 18th in the nation just a few weeks ago before that upset loss at Jacksonville State. And we'll pay a lot of attention to that. What's important for Tennessee State is they want to win this conference. And obviously this afternoon they must win this football game here on the road in order to do just that.
Well, it's been a long stretch of games without a week off for TSU. They won't get their bye week until next week. It'll be a stretch of 10 straight. It's like Ward should have enough for a first down at the 43.
And they finish up the season the week after. You're right, a very odd spot for that. And also keep in mind, you know, in comparison to other teams in this conference, Tennessee State travels a lot. They play in the Black Heritage Games, and they do a lot of traveling. So that bye week in the middle of the season might have been a little more appropriate, a little helpful to them, but not the case this season.
Of course, one of the big stories for this team is a return to Hale Stadium in Nashville, where they played for so many years. Ward to the outside, trying to push his way into Murray State territory, does so as he's knocked out at the 48.
By number 38, Darryl Smith.
Rod Reed, their head coach, one of the players that played in Hale Stadium, the whole in the heyday of TSU football. And then Tennessee State again using the facilities of LP Field in Nashville that's shared by the Tennessee Titans, and now kind of a split schedule this season. Still went back there for homecoming against Arkansas Pine Bluff and had a huge crowd.
Second and 2. The carry by Ward. We'll get it again here, trying to move the chains for Tennessee State. Somebody lost a shoe down there.
The carry again. Tackle made by number 91, Io Ojaloa.
It was Jeremy Brackett, the defensive lineman for Murray State. Chains will move for Tennessee State as balls at the 46.
It'll be up for the first down, first and 10, Tennessee.
Keeping updated on Travis State, Ward now. 16 carries for 53 yards, a touchdown early on. Right back to the line, the Tigers here. Quick screen right side, this is James. Crosses the 40.
To number 6, Travis James.
The senior out of Fort Lauderdale. Lots of players from the Sunshine State this game.
Yeah, lots of them, and they're enjoying this weather a little bit more than some Eastern Kentucky players for the Sunshine State last night. And, of course, James getting a nice block out there by Devin Wilson, his fellow wide receiver out of Nashville. And then James again weaving his way for a nice gain on first down. Gives you a lot of opportunities here, second and short.
Yeah, they had second and 2 and went to Ward for a first down last time. We'll see what Michael German, this offense, have in store here. Heavy to the right of the formation. Ward.
Travis Ward.
About a yard short.
Number 55,
third and 1.
Jenkins.
My money's on coming back to Travis Ward on that third and 1 you just talked about right then, Kevin. Again, Murray State sliding down. They showed a little bit of a run blitz, kind of anticipating that. And I think pretty safe to anticipate it here at this point. But Tennessee State now getting away from their penalty prone
situation they had in the first quarter now, and now putting another sustained drive together.
I saw Blake Salter, Mike linebacker out of Florence, Alabama for Murray State. Run play and a first down for TSU as Ward gets the call.
Now on the average, Murray State has been okay against the run this season, but they haven't seen some of the outstanding running backs in the conference. We're going to see Matt Denham next week. They're seeing Travis Ward this afternoon. And that may move that number up a little bit more because the quality of running backs that they've seen hasn't quite gotten to the peak of the OVC. They're experiencing that now and again next week at Eastern Kentucky.
German directing traffic with the three receivers to the left, letting Joe Bowens know where he wants him lined up here. Drop and throw, complete, Leonard. Short gain to the 31.
To number one, A.C. Leonard. Tackle made by number 21, Darius Buck.
Darius Buck trying to jump the route. You see him in your picture right there, and he's undersized defensive back going up against A.C. Leonard at 6'3". You're saying, well, that's only 4 inches. Well, it makes a big difference because Leonard is a very strong guy in the upper body, and that's why a lot of people, Kevin, project him to be an NFL prospect.
Second and seven after that three-yard gain, and Darius Buck listed at 5'9 and 175, senior from Vicksburg, Mississippi. Played some junior college ball before arriving here in Murray. Big hole for Ward. Down to the 24.
We're
about a half yard short of a first down.
At Kadeem Edwards, 6'3", 290 on that offensive line. Responsible for that block right there. Take a look down the line. Ward's going to run right behind him. Edwards gets that seal block, and Ward does the rest.
Play made by Brandon Wicks for Murray State. 8 minutes left, second quarter. TSU trying to go back in front. They led 7-0 early.
This might be a spot where you throw the football third and inches.
Instead, they give to Ward. And I don't know.
Travis Ward on the carry once again. Tackle made by number 91.
I think he may have it.
It'll be nothing. The first down, first and 10. Tennessee.
See, I told you they should have ripped the football.
Yeah, that's why we're not offensive coordinators, I think.
Well, I just thought, you know, given where you were on the field, the situation there, and got that big tight end that you can throw to just in a short route to pick up a yard or two if need be.
Already 20 carries for Travis Ward. Had a 43 carry, 267 day at Southeast Missouri. Scored 4 touchdowns earlier this season. A lot of wear and tear, but has shown he can carry the load. Play action here. German looking downfield. Pocket collapses, still on his feet. Got it away. Ball came loose at the end. I think that was Bowens.
Bowens was in blocking, so therefore he's an eligible receiver in that situation.
Number two, Corey Addison.
Nice improvisation by German, and he held on as long as he could, Kevin, and that pocket literally did collapse around him. You'll watch.
1 yard on the play.
Watching, down, looking, down nine. The field, nothing there. Bowens will slip out of his block. Give me the ball. And he gets it, and Bowens will take off. And he'll end up fumbling out of bounds, but take a look at the progress and watch the spot right there by the official.
Well, he saw Adrian Dinkins, the defensive end for Murray, hanging on there, trying to get the sack. Ward with the carry.
Well, Travis Ward on
set
the carry.
Up third and about seven.
Number 39, Blake Salter.
And while you always look to score touchdowns in this situation, keep in mind that the kicking game has been very good for Tennessee State. With Jamin Godfrey, Player of the Week in the Ohio Valley Conference as far as specialists go last week. Big performance in, and the lefty would like to get a chance here, but it would like to be it in the case of an extra point.
6 minutes left, first half. Tigers trying to go back in front. Leonard over the middle to the 15.
He'll
be about a half yard short.
Leonard, tackle made by number 21, Darius Buck.
Leonard looks a little shaken up, slow getting up. He's going to be all right.
Look at those arms on him for a tight end. Just a big, strong guy going to come across.
and the cornerback must pick him up in that situation. And
it'll be fourth down. And the
Raider was just checking his mark there, Kevin. It will be fourth and short.
TSU gonna try to keep it going here. On the season on fourth down, 8 of 12. German, let's see.
Michael German on the carry.
He's gonna have enough.
Running behind this offensive line is a joy, but look, German's bounced once, denied twice, and then finally finds a little slither.
He got a little shove in the back there, too, I think, from maybe Travis James.
Oh, we didn't see that.
Bring the chains out and measure.
That's called teamwork.
You ask USC about that a few years ago. By half the football.
It'll be enough for the first down, first and 10, Tennessee State.
Travis Ward with an assist on that.
Not sure if it was Ward or James, one or the other, though. It looked like they tried to help out a little bit.
That's a big first down. So now you're in the red zone, and that's where Tennessee State has been very effective, 84% in scoring while in the red zone this season. 63 of those coming with touchdowns inside the red zone, percentage-wise, 63.
Put it at the 14, first and 10. German going to pull it down and run. Lots of room in the middle and inside the 5 to set up first and goal.
Michael German.
Good job recognizing where the opening was. See him shaking the right arm a little after that tackle.
The referee blew the whistle. He's going to talk to the back judge. I'm not quite sure what that was about, but it seemed like each of the Tennessee State receivers on their routes were into the corner of the end zone, and they truly did open up that middle. And I think German had to be surprised at how much running room. Once he got to the edge, he realized he had toward the middle of the field. That's where he tucked it up and ran.
Well, Coach Rod Reed saying German, the redshirt year, really helped him settle down. He's limited his mistakes. They knew he was special when they first saw him on campus, and he has delivered this season. First and goal from the 2. Heavy to the left of the formation as they go with the multiple tight ends, and Ward is tripped up for a loss. That was T-Ray Malone again. He's been busy today for Murray. Corey Addison as well, you see him.
Very dry surface here, artificial surface, and Ward just loses his footing. Probably was anticipating T-Ray Malone coming through, but went to the turf rather quickly.
Well, mistakes inside the red zone. Issues for the TSU offense last week. They'll have it here. Second and goal at the 6. Play fake. German rolls. Sends it toward the corner and out of the reach of Bowens, incomplete.
German pass intended for number 81, Joe Bowens.
German keeping that play alive, but the issue there was to throw it away and avoid any problems you might have with an interception deep in the end zone. That's a pretty smart play by German right then to settle TSU down into a third down. And this is a pretty big third down situation here, because obviously you'd like to score a touchdown if you're Tennessee State right before the end of the half.
44% on third downs on the season for TSU, trailing 10-7. Late first half, 3.5 minutes to play. And TSU will take a timeout before the important 3rd and 6. We'll go to the break as well. 10-7, Murray State leading Tennessee State. OBC football here on Fox College Sports. Follow the OVC on Facebook and Twitter. Get up-to-the-minute information from around the Ohio Valley Conference. Hear it first from the OVC staff by following the conference on your social media platform. Go to OVCSports.com for a direct link to all OVC social media. Well, TSU hoping to tweet about a scoring drive here, third and six, or third and goal with the ball at the six, I should say. German on play action, rolls out on the boot. Trying to decide whether to throw a run. He made the right choice. Touchdown to Garlington.
Touchdown, Tennessee State.
Got the ball in there, and Garlington with the reception. It's his first TD of the season.
The German rolling out to the right. Leonard, the tight end, was tight to the right. It was blocking and ready to release as well. He had three receivers right in the back of the corner of the end zone for German to choose from. And Garlington, from Antioch, Tennessee, just outside of Nashville, the recipient, far back corner of the end zone.
TSU back in front, trying to make it a 14-10 game.
And it's
able to do so.
Score,
conversion
14,
by Godfrey.
State,
and we'll
10.
Take a break as well. 3:27 to go, opening half. 14 for TSU, 10 for Murray State. Back in just a moment. OVC football on Fox College Sports.
A few weeks ago, someone told the remote small town of Bethel, Alaska, they were getting a Taco Bell. But they were crushed to find out it was only a hoax. Well, it's time somebody delivered some good news. Along with 10,000 Doritos Locos Tacos.
Who wants Taco Bell?
The Doritos Locos Tacos, taking tacos where they've never been before.
In the NCAA Division I Football Championship Subdivision, the game is played with perseverance, integrity, passion, character, and sportsmanship as he works to honor the game and respect his teammates, opponents, officials, and fans. Every FCS player grows in his responsibilities as a student athlete and as a member of his campus and community. The NCAA Division I Football Championship Subdivision, every down, every day.
When you buy tickets at Ticket City, you're being helped by a real human being. What's behind other ticketing websites? Your Ticket City representative can guide you to the best seats, let you know when your tickets are coming, and show affection to animals. As for those other websites, it's like they're not even trying.
Nothing is more precious than a child's life, and no one believes that more than the Children's Organ Transplant Association.
Fox Sports asks you to...
A play-action touchdown German to Garlington has TSU in front. Very close to the line of scrimmage, but got it away in time, and a nice catch by Garlington. First touchdown reception of the season for the sophomore from Brentwood Academy. Murray State had scored 10 unanswered points after TSU took an early 7-0 lead. And that series was, or a scoring drive, I should say, 18 plays, 68 yards, and 9:30. Two long scoring drives for TSU. Shorter, as you might expect, the way this offense runs for Murray State. Fair catch requested at the 29, and Murray State will set things
fair
up.
Fair catch for the Racers, number 38, Gerald Smith. It'll be first and 10.
TSU scoring drives have been 12 plays, 80 yards at 5:04, and as we mentioned, 18-68 in 9:30. The scoring drives for Murray State, Brockman to Powell. That was a 5-play, 65-yard drive in less than a minute. And a 3-minute drive has covered 50 yards for a field goal late in the first quarter.
Another look at Casey Brockman, 79 yards passing so far, and we keep talking about those numbers, but the kinds of numbers he's putting up are staggering. We'll kind of place him nationally after this play.
From the gun on first down. They tried that a couple times. A little Statue of Liberty look, and out to the 34 on the carry. They went to Dwayne Brady, the junior from St. Augustine, Florida.
And when you throw the football real well, this works real well with play action. Nice job there by Brockman to fake the throw into the right side and hand it off to the running back.
He'll fake and run himself this time. Scampers to the 40 and rolls down at the 48-yard line. Well, he's shown he's got pretty good wheels a couple times today when they've needed him to. Move the chains for Murray, but just under 3 minutes to play in the first half.
And every time he's run, he's converted. Fourth, third down, and here on second down, just wide open field for him to run into.
Look for the screen on the right, wasn't there. Lofts it left side, picked off. Flag on the play.
Blackman's pass is intercepted, but there is a flag on the play.
Pick was made by, I think it was David Van Dyke on the interception. We'll see the penalty, though. I think it's going to go against TSU.
Yeah, Patrick Robinson, the intended receiver, and that's experience with Brockman and Robertson working. Brockman, a little bit of trouble, kind of gave that nod.
Holy. First down.
So Brockman, not a lot of pressure, but watch Robinson top of his screen. At that point, he sees he and Brockman make eye contact, nod the helmet, and then he goes down the field. And the defensive back for Tennessee State coming over with a hold.
The wipe off, it would have been a third interception of the season for Van Dyke, and make it a first down for Murray State. Complete out of the backfield, Brady to make the catch. Progress to the 36. Take another look.
And Brady's going to sneak out here to the left. Try and pick up a block, but not a really good job right then. Robertson trying to put a shoulder into the defender, but just really didn't get a good block for him.
Carry this time for the 34. Brady coming in with 30 receptions for 233 and a touchdown on the season. His first catch of the day. And as we figured coming in, Murray State has mixed up the targets. Seven different folks have caught passes today. Injured player.
And
it's Brady, just maybe a cramp the way he's stretching.
Number 6,
don't see a lot of those at this point in time in November, but I agree with you. I think it's exactly what it is. And, you know, when you're able to throw the ball all over the yard like Brockman can, you got to keep those receivers happy. And as you mentioned, seven different ones have touched the football, now eight. And those are, keeps everybody happy. And also poses a threat, you know, to your opponent defensively. Lots of different looks, lots of different formations. That's the other thing that's kind of jumped out at me about Murray State this afternoon is lots of different looks. They give the defense a lot to think about.
Third down and
it's funny, you look at some of the stats we have in front of us here. TSU, only six different players have touched the football on offense, but for Murray, they've had eight different receivers, three rushers, including Barry. Big yardage here, may have a touchdown, and from 35 yards, Jamal Barry puts Murray State back in front.
Back and forth we go, but this time the running game, very important for Murray State, and a very nice run by Barry, just finding his way through the secondary. Once he got to the second level, it became all Barry at that time, and Barry knew how to find the end zone. It's Murray State back in the lead.
And a back and forth first half, and with a minute 44 to play. Murray trying to again take a 3-point lead with the extra point.
Kick is up, and it's good.
Kick for Benton on the money, 17-14. Racers leading the Tigers. A break in the action here. OVC football on Fox College Sports.
In the NC Day.
Well, Racer one getting some work in this first half. Minute 44 to play. Murray State back in front of Tennessee State 17-14. Bring OVC football here on Fox College Sports from Murray, Kentucky. Stewart Stadium, Kevin Ingram with Bob Bellman. Jamal Barry, his fifth touchdown rush of the season, the junior Ohio State transfer, 35-yard run. Bounce to the outside and took it to the house. TSU will get another try before we head to the intermission.
Aren't you impressed with the number of transfers from FBS schools to come back down to the Ohio Valley Conference and been impactful. And it almost looks like for some of the schools in this conference, Kevin, almost a recruiting strategy of sorts to try and find them. And there are a lot that dot both of these rosters this afternoon. Primarily, you see a lot Tennessee State, Jacksonville State are the two that kind of jump out at me.
Pop-up catch, fair catch made.
Fair catch by number 41, Vernon Fred.
Fred made that.
It'll be first and 10, Tennessee State, on about their own 30-yard line.
See if where they put it down. Should be around the 30-yard line. But Bob, you're right as far as the transfers go. And that's something we talked to Jack Crow about, the Jacksonville State coach, a couple weeks ago. We talked about, you know, getting those guys in and sort of integrating them within your program and making sure they fit in and the playing time's appropriate for them. But also what a key part they are of FCS programs. You get a couple guys who've transferred down that have played in, you know, big-time leagues and can really give your program a lift. And we talk about A.C. Leonard for Tennessee State, good player at Florida, and certainly a big part of what the Tigers are doing. German, play action, first down, lobs it to the right side and incomplete. Looking for Travis James.
German pass intended for number six, Travis James, is incomplete.
And James has been a solid target for German this afternoon, but I think German may have had a good opportunity there to kind of tuck it and run and get 8 or 10 yards. He had his receivers, all of which in deep routes, which really cleared the underneath off. All he had to beat in that situation was a linebacker, and he's got the talent and the athletic skills to be able to do that.
One thing here too, Bob, if you're TSU, you want to move the ball and try to score, but you also want to try to run the clock out on this series and not give Murray another chance as quickly as they can move it down the field and maybe put something else on the board before the half gets here. German will send it underneath this time.
Pass is complete.
That catch.
To number 18, Telvin Hooks.
Made by Telvin Hooks. First time we called his name today.
On the play. Bring up
out of the backfield to make the reception.
Well, in this situation, Travis Ward is not in the game. You see Hooks in the backfield. We saw Tim Broughton bought in a couple weeks ago at Jacksonville State to spell Ward at about this point in time of the game.
Well, Hooks lost the football. Play. Murray State says they have it. The officials agree. A big turnover for TSU will give the Racers the football with just over a minute to go in the half and inside Tiger territory.
Turnovers are never good. Murray State committing one in the red zone. This one in the middle of the field. Hooks just trying to get that extra yard or two, and now the strip. Actually, it's more of a great defensive play than it was Hooks trying to get the extra yard or two. They're still trying to separate it in the middle of the field. Now the Murray State player comes out, spikes the ball. That's going to cost Murray State 15 yards.
Yeah, we saw
as we get back to live action, yeah.
Before that.
Well, there's only three or four on the field that I can see at this point, so it may take a moment or two to sort this out. So the referee, Dunaway, says, what did you see? And what did you see? Here's what I saw. And this is good officiating, though. This is how this works. Here's what I saw. And you got to watch this crew work together. And that's exactly what you want to see in these kinds of situations. And there's a lot to sort out at this point.
Well, the bad news is, either way, it's bad news for TSU anyway. It's going to be Murray's football. Regardless of where they'll start the drive, they have plenty of time with just over a minute to go.
Plenty of firepower. Chris Hatcher is going to come out to the numbers, the Murray State coach.
Get the explanation from Todd Dunaway here shortly.
There are three fouls. Personal foul on the offense. Personal foul on the defense. Those fouls offset. After the recovery, we have an unsportsmanlike conduct on the defense, number 91. The ball was recovered by Murray State. That penalty will assess and first down, Murray State.
You taking notes on that, Kevin?
Yeah, I tried to get all that.
Actually, the defense at the time was Murray State, so that's the guilty party right there. That was a spike.
And Ayo Ojolowa was the guilty party on the unsportsmanlike call, so that'll put it at the 38.
38-yard line.
And even with an explosive offense, that's a very bad penalty to get in that situation because your time left in the game, or left in the half, rather. It's not all that much. And again, you've got a high-octane offense here. You may have to throw the ball deeper on first down to try and offset for that penalty.
So here's Brockman in the offense for the Racers, leading 17-14. 35-yard touchdown run by Jamal Berry put him in front moments ago. Complete. Midfield. Nice. Catch and run
five,
there
Patrick
as
Robertson.
They went to Patrick Robertson.
That completion is good enough for another Racer.
That's Brockman. He'll find Robertson.
Ten,
now the rest is Robertson. Would not be denied. Spins. It's another 7 or 8 yards.
Didn't take long. Already at the 41. Brockman looking for some room to the outside. Will pick up a couple. Murray Casey has Brockman two timeouts remaining. So does TSU.
Back to your point earlier, Murray wants to be the team that scores with no time left on the clock here in the half.
38 seconds. Brockman going for it all here. Got it. Touchdown. Walter Powell with the reception, 38 yards. And Murray tacks on another score with 32 seconds. Flag back at the 42, though.
We do have a flag on the play.
Number 62, 10-yard penalty.
Well, Roderick Tomlin penalized on the right side of the offensive line, so wipe off the score.
Holding penalty on the Racers.
Great job then by Powell. Again, Hatcher's favorite target, the junior out of St. Louis, and he was indeed wide open. No safety help in the middle of the field by Tennessee State. Now watch Brockman.
Penalty moves the ball back to the Tennessee State.
Pretty much
State.
Looking Powell all the way and finds him.
Line.
I think we saw the... what they determined was the hold right before Brockman threw the football. Make it second and 17. Just shy of midfield. Pass over the hands of Watkins and incomplete.
Pass intended for number 17, Dontell Watkins is incomplete.
Player with a helmet off. That's got to mean a departure from the game.
Samquan Evans.
Yeah, two key penalties here against Murray State. Obviously, a penalty that wipes out a touchdown is devastating. But, you know, the question is, can they overcome it? And what is your strategy here on third and 17? Do you try and get half of it and go for it on fourth? Do you try to get the first down, move to the middle of the field, and try a field goal attempt?
Third and 17, 24 seconds. Big collision and an incompletion. That was Powell again.
Pass intended for number 9, Walter Powell is incomplete. That'll bring
so
up
now
fourth
and 17.
Daniel Fitzpatrick is going to come in and put the big hit from the secondary here for Tennessee State. Right there, knocks it loose. And Powell unable to get the first down on the reception. Not a good series for him because he had a touchdown wiped off because of the holding penalty.
Steven Mix to punt. Garlington at his 12. And it will roll out at the 16.
Mix's punt is out of bounds at the Tennessee
For Murray,
State
that has to be a big disappointment. But for TSU, that's a bullet dodge there.
It is, and I'm wondering if you're TSU, if you just don't chuck it down the field here with 15 seconds remaining here in the half and see what you can do with the football.
17-14, you see the score. Murray State in front. Tennessee State, an 8-1 mark overall, 4-1 in the OVC, only loss against Jacksonville State a couple weeks back. Murray is 3-5 on the season, 2-3 in conference play. Put it to 15 for the Tigers. Murray's going to call time. Looked like TSU might just line up in a victory formation right there, I thought, and just maybe kneel it down and go to the locker room.
Anchors Hatcher's got the philosophy, you can't take them with you. So you're going to call them, but something personnel-wise for Tennessee State did not sit well with the scouting report of Murray State in that situation, because I agree with you, they appear to go with a victory formation, and that is simply to run the clock out to take a knee, and we would be done with a quarter in that situation. So there's something that sparked this time out on behalf of Murray State.
Well, other games going on in the Ohio Valley, Jacksonville State at UT Martin. Culver Stockton plays at Austin Peay, Eastern Kentucky at Southeast Missouri State, Eastern Illinois at Tennessee Tech. Mentioned some of the other games going on. We'll keep an eye on Vanderbilt with a big lead over Kentucky at half. halftime 27-0. Tennessee 28-17, about 5 minutes to play in the first half over in Knoxville. And Texas A&M 24-0 over Mississippi State at the half. And TSU will indeed kneel it down and call it a half. Trailing by three at the break. They rallied to win last week at home against Tennessee Tech. We'll have to come from behind to win this football game, but only down a field goal at the break. Murray State 17, Tennessee 14 at the intermission. Casey Brockman, 107 yards and a touchdown in the first half. Michael German for TSU, 10 of 18 for 81 and a score. Travis Ward, 22 carries for 62 yards and a touchdown in the first half for the Tigers. So we'll go to the break. Murray in front by three. OVC football on Fox College Sports. Welcome back, 17-14. The home team, Murray State, leading visiting Tennessee State. We're at halftime, our OVC game of the week on Fox College Sports. The Ohio Valley Conference and its member institutions pride themselves on developing student athletes who excel in the classroom, in the community, and on the playing field, of course. The league's proud to say that each year over 100 football players are selected to the OVC Commissioner's Honor Roll. And this week, the conference would like to recognize from Tennessee State, Nick Thrasher, and from Murray State, Julian Whitehead. You see Nick there out of Morrow, Georgia. Named Defensive Player of the Week October 8th, Commissioner's Honor Roll selection last season, and a member of the TSU Athletic Director's Honor Roll. 3.8 GPA, outstanding work by Nick, and good player on the field, too. And for Murray State, Julian Whitehead, a defensive back, grad student out of Stone Mountain, Georgia. 3.57 GPA, you see it there. Graduated early from Ole Miss, then enrolled at Murray State. He's been on the Dean's List every semester while here in Murray. So congratulations, Julian Whitehead out of Stone Mountain, Georgia. Nick Thrasher from Morrow, Georgia. Both from the Peach State and both are student athletes of the week as honored by the Ohio Valley Conference. Congratulations. Do that every week. And good to see folks who not only play well, but perform well in the classroom. Take a timeout. Come back with your first half highlights and stats in just a moment. 17-14, Murray State leading Tennessee State. Halftime, OVC Game of the Week on Fox College Sports. Tennessee State getting ready for the second half. Good ball game here in Murray, Kentucky. TSU an 8-1 record overall, 4-1 of the OVC. Murray State 2-3 in conference play and 3-5 on the season. And look at the offensive numbers in the first half. Murray 244 yards of total offense and TSU 161. Murray will get the football. They won the toss and deferred to start the game, and Godfrey will kick it off. Another short kick. Seen several of those today. Returned out to the 32 as Jeremy Harness caught the short one, and Murray State will set things up from the 32, 33-yard line. Sideline for TSU is going to look at some of the first half stats. Casey Brockman, 107 yards and a half, be pretty good for most people, but for him, kind of an off day, huh?
Oh, not at all. In fact, they hurt themselves with two chances with a turnover and turning it over on downs. He would have had more chances right then. I like what TSU is doing. When you look at the numbers, TSU controlling the football, time of possession.
Quickly outside, catch, Powell, big gain into TSU territory in the first play from scrimmage to the 38.
That's the way to get you started if you're Murray State. Go back to that combination that's been so good for you all season long and get Powell in space. You hear coaches and colleagues in our industry talk about that, but Powell is very effective when he's out in space, the junior from St. Louis.
Third catch of the day and has his fourth for a 2 or 3 yard gain. Came in with four straight games of over 10 receptions, four straight 100-yard plus games in terms of yardage.
4 yards on the play. Bring him second down and six.
Second and six. They gave him four. Brockman from the shotgun, Walter Payton Award watch list member. There's that man again. Powell for another first down and inside the 15.
Well, Powell totally exposing the Tennessee State secondary that's had its share of personnel issues. And right then, Burnell Brooks, who happened to come up with a good play toward the end of the first half, that time got burned badly. And Powell just moved on a dime, Kevin, got the first down. Murray State in business.
Davis in, Powell out. Run for Berry, scored a first half touchdown. And good run defense by the Tigers. White jerseys to the football as they closed up the hole.
And one of the things early on you've noticed, at least in the first half and carrying here a little bit early in the second half, very early in the second half, in fact, is a tendency for Murray State to kind of clamp down a little bit when they get in the red zone and go to that running game. They're becoming a little more predictable. They still need to get medium, short type of passes into Brockman's repertoire and be more effective with the passing game in a shrunk field.
No gain, second and 10. Brockman's pass incomplete. Look for Harness. Had a catch in the first half, one of eight. Make it nine different receivers in the opening 30 minutes of football.
And Brooks and Kirkpatrick are the two defensive backs that Brockman has tried to pick on. And now that diamond formation with the receivers at the bottom of your screen.
On third and 10, looks that way. Throws incomplete, Powell. Coverage there by Burnell Brooks. Getting more work today with the injury to Stephen Godbolt. Mentioned off the top, concussion last week. Not available today for TSU. Big loss in the secondary for the Tigers, but get a hold here, and it'll be a field goal try for Murray.
And we talked about the absence of Godbolt and the changes and the shifts Tennessee State has had to make. And then you look at the numbers that Brogman's been putting up all season. He's already got 161 yards so far in the game, but not those eye-popping numbers he's been putting up in weeks past.
Here's Benton from 31. Have to try it again. It'll make it a 36-yard try after the explanation from Todd Dunaway, the referee.
And that's very near Brockman's longest of the season.
At 39 has been his best. Benton hit a 25-yarder back at the end of the first quarter to give Murray its first lead of the day at 10-7. 35-yard touchdown run by Jamal Berry put him on top 17-14.
36-yard field goal.
They got a turnover toward the end of the first half, couldn't do anything with it. Now from 36, here's Benton.
And it's good.
Knocks it through to make it 20-14, Murray State. Opening drive of the second half, successful for the Razors as they add three. We'll take a timeout. TSU gets the football in a moment. OVC football on Fox College Sports. Gorgeous day for football in Murray, Kentucky. Razors leading Tennessee State 20-14. Third quarter action, OVC football on Fox College Sports. Bob Belvin, I'm Kevin Ingram. That is not Bob, the Racer mascot suit.
I don't have moves that good.
So now leading 20-14, Murray will kick it off. TSU will get his first try of the second half. Garlington, big opening. Garlington might be taking this one to the house. Bottled up at around the 30. Good angle by Murray to track him down. They're a huge return for Weldon Garlington all the way to the 29.
That's unquestionably a short field to work with. Julian Whitehead making the tackle. We mentioned him in the Scholar Athlete piece just a few moments ago, but Garlington really getting a good jump start here to the second half for Tennessee State with that return.
Given 66 yards on the return. Take another look.
Not a lot of people get a hand on him, Kevin, and certainly when you let a speedster into the open field like that, tried to cut back, and finally Murray State got a hand on him.
It was Benton, I think the kicker that had the angle. About 2 minutes deep, third quarter. Nicely done Completion made at the 15. They worked at that time to Devin Wilson, the senior. College Scholar Athlete Award from the National Football Foundation of Middle Tennessee back earlier this year.
Nice safe route by Wilson. It's the out route. Either he catches it or it's incomplete. And Wilson does his job and moves the chains early for Tennessee State.
First and 10, 15-yard line inside the red zone for TSU. They have problems with penalties last week, hoping to have some of that solved here today. And looking at a touchdown deficit as they go to Ward for the first down carry, gain of one. In the first half, he had 22 totes for 62 yards and a touchdown. That put TSU in front early on, a two-yard score.
Again, T-Ray Malone filling the gap for Murray State and wrapping up Travis Ward.
T-Ray Malone, and as mentioned earlier, an outstanding player for Smyrna High School and down in the Murfreesboro area, one of the best districts you'll see in high school football, certainly in the Volunteer State. Ward will carry to the six.
And we haven't seen Tim Broughton. We saw another running back in earlier. Remember, Broughton came in. I guess Jacksonville State kind of spelled Ward, but again, Ward's going to be the workhorse. A little stretch play to the left side, let it pick his hole, and there was indeed a hole there for him to pick from all the way to the six-yard line.
That works well for TSU, doesn't it? Especially when you have those terrific offensive linemen on the left side run that stretch, and they can get out there and make the blocks they need to.
Well, it's clearly a hat-on-hat, so it's straight-up blocking for the offensive linemen, and they like that.
Ward carries on third and one. Michael German saying, yeah, we got enough for a first down. Officials will take a look as they spot it at the five. And it'll be first and goal for TSU. Big return by Garlington. Tennessee State hoping they can cash in and maybe take the lead here, trailing by six. Played about 4 minutes in this third quarter. Jumbo formation for the Tigers. Ward trying to get to the edge and will run out at the 3 or 4 yard line.
Good pursuit then from this vantage point. It looked like Ward was going to be able to get right to that pylon in the corner there, and pursuit coming from the other side. Doug McWhorter is going to come through here and make the play for Murray. Read it, come down the line, just get beyond Edwards, the offensive lineman, and knock him out of bounds.
They gave him enough to the two. Take a look there, Brandon Hathaway, also from Smyrna, Tennessee, a freshman. Here's Ward, falls forward, just short of the goal line. About the half yard line is where he made it.
I got a feeling we might see the sequel to that play in this situation, given where the ball is. Very, very close to the goal line.
About as close as you can be without it actually touching the line. It'll be third and goal from the one.
So it's not quite the call to the post here at Murray State, but it's the for whom the bell tolls here on third down. And the Racers do indeed need a big stop here to keep Tennessee State out of the end zone.
High formation. German on the sneak. He got it. Touchdown, TSU. Tie ball game at 20. Mike German, his second rushing touchdown of the year. 1 yard on that one.
German comes right over, thinks his big offensive lineman, Kadeem Edwards. Good block. Watch Edwards, he's 73 right in the middle of it, and German will just follow his lead into the end zone.
So an extra point to regain the lead for the Tigers. And it's on the money for Godfrey, 21-20 Tennessee State, with an answer here in the third to go back in front. Take a break. We'll check out the touchdown by German when we come back. 1 point lead for TSU, OVC football on Fox College Sports.
Imagine.
1 yard score by Michael German, the Tennessee State quarterback, has the Tigers back in front of Murray State, 21-20. The Just under 10 minutes to play, third quarter here in Murray, Kentucky. Home team about to get the football for the second time in this half. Big kickoff return by Weldon Garlington, setting things up from the 28, and TSU able to punch it in. This will be Powell on the return for Murray. He's going to have some room. Almost to midfield. Powell averages 24 yards per return and got that and then some, as he'll have it at the 47 for the Racers.
Talk about versatility. We haven't talked a lot about Powell returning kicks today, but a nice one then. And again, good starting field position. He's going to get beyond this wall of blockers and then go to the left side, find himself a little avenue right there. And then again, big yardage.
A 31-yard return, 32 officially, 47 for Casey Brockman in this offense for Murray State. A field goal on their opening drive of the second half. Trying to direct traffic and unload incomplete. Contact over on that sideline as Dwayne Brady was there, number six.
And Brockman continues to amaze in terms of buying time, stretching the play out, and then trying to get along the right sideline. Brady open with a little pump fake and then kind of a routine type of thing with your wide receiver trying to break him free. Just couldn't do it.
Brady will get the handoff. Run to the TSU side of midfield. Saw big Dinsdale Jackson, redshirt freshman out of Miami Gardens, Florida, on the stop. 6'3 and 290. They average 261 up front, TSU does. The starting four anyway, 245, 290, 290, and 240. Third and six. Fake to Barry. Brockman pressured from behind, and they got him. A sack by Marquavius Jackson.
The first time this afternoon, and I bragged about Brockman extending the play and buying some time two snaps ago. Not the case in Marquavius Jackson. The pressure from the backside wraps him up. Now Brockman really stayed down low in that play fake, and then Marquavius Jackson kind of surprised him a little bit. He think that pressure was coming, just didn't feel it that time.
Saw Greg Barksdale as well. Had trouble protecting the quarterback there. Garlington. Well, that was a dangerous play and might have been better off just to let that one go in the end. Had to pick it up after he touched it. It'll be at the 1 yard line for TSU.
Boy, that's a special teams blunder. And again, the kick had everything to do with it, or the punt rather, in terms of how it bounced off that turf. It became difficult to handle. Watch this. Talk about E6 if he were a shortstop. And he was, boy, that's very close to a Murray State touchdown. But again, going to rule his forward progress was stopped while he had the ball across the goal line, extended it to the 1 yard line.
So now this TSU offense will come back onto the field, but a lot of green in front of them here.
That will not win you a gold glove right then.
Well, so win the favor of Coach Rod Reed either.
And what a difference a possession makes, right? You started your opponent's 28 after the Garlington kickoff return. Now you botch a punt and you start at your own one.
Yeah, it was 66 yards to the 28 on the previous kick return. So Michael German standing on the Murray State blue. Hands to Travis Ward and just got out of there to the one. Before he was wrapped up by Matthews.
Very curious if Murray State will load the box here and anticipate another run again by Travis Ward, just in an attempt to get some breathing room.
Take another look. Actually, it was T. Ray Malone. Called his name a bunch today from that Will linebacker spot. Ward again, just trying to make it out of the end zone. Murray wanting a safety, but they're going to mark it about the 1 foot line.
Well, if I'm Murray State, I'm also thinking about what can I do to block this punt if I can force it. That's what makes this third down very important for Murray State.
Here's Ward trying to get in there behind Anthony Woods. Third and 10, 1 foot line. Two wides left and one to the right for Michael German. A yard deep in his own end zone will throw. To Leonard, got him. 35 yard line. Leonard trying to walk the tightrope, can't do it, but a nice recovery by TSU from the 1 foot line to the 47 of Murray State.
So when you get in trouble, you go to your sure-handed tight end. Now German's going to roll to the left, going to get a little bit of pressure. The pressure's going to come up the middle. He's going to roll to the left. See him lift his head right then. It's almost an eye contact kind of thing. And obviously, if Coleman is able to stay in bounds, it probably is the longest pass and catch reception in TSU history. Instead, he goes out of bounds at the Murray 47, which is still a fantastic conversion out of the danger of your own end zone.
Yeah, I think that would have been 99 and two-third yards for A.C. Leonard.
How do we put that in the record books had that gone down?
Be right, that would have been
asterisk.
Record play. The officials maybe trying to sort out a clock issue here. 6:41 to go, third quarter. Tennessee State leading 21-20. Big escape there for the Tigers. Like Murray was going to get it back and be in great shape to have a shot at retaking the lead.
The referees come to the far side to speak to Ron Reed, so there must be a clock malfunction of some sorts. He's made his way to both sidelines, as Todd Dunaway. Now he's going to explain to Michael German, the quarterback, as to where to expect his play clock to come from.
Well, it's been a half of big plays for TSU, a huge kickoff return that set up a score, and now German to Leonard to place the football on the Murray State side of midfield. After TSU was backed up to its one, ran out successfully on first and second down, but now in much better shape. They'll give it to the man Ward, and he'll push it forward to the 45 on a short gain. For Ward, that's his 30th rushing attempt, had 76 yards before that carry. German on the day, 12 of 20, 146 and a touchdown.
Well, you can just kind of feel Murray State a little deflated about not being able to either get a safety moments ago or force TSU to punt and in turn probably get good field position on that big play from German to Leonard. And that's, you just could kind of feel a little bit of a letdown defensively among this crowd.
Second and 7. It was very close to a safety on the second down play. German will zip it to Leonard, and he'll have a first down at the 34.
Lines up tight on the right side and just comes back across the formation again. And that German to Leonard combination really been a problem for Murray State in this possession and practically all game long.
5.5 remaining, third quarter, 1-point lead, TSU in front, trying to maintain its lead in the Ohio Valley Conference standings. Three teams at 4-1, TSU, UT Martin, Eastern Illinois, all entering today's play with 4 wins and 5 tries. Here's Ward again with his carries now standing at 31 on the day. Had that 43 rush game at SEMO a few weeks back. Maybe threatening that before we're done here. That was a loss of one.
Loss of one on the play.
I think you got an interesting play call coming up right here on second and 11. Do you become predictable if you're Tennessee State and go back with Ward again? Not a bad option, but I'm saying it just kind of builds some predictability that you can allow Murray State to properly defense.
He's a single setback. Quickly left side James and out at the 27. now. It'll bring up third and four.
Tennessee State on the season only converting 44%. That's not a bad number against, you know, the national average. You know, a couple weeks ago, we bragged about Jacksonville State. They're 51-52%, somewhere along those lines. So 44%, not all that bad. But the important thing about third down is keeping it manageable. This is the case right now for Tennessee State.
Ward, nice running to get the first down. They'll put it at the 26 and move the chains for the Tigers.
And remember, this is a TSU team we talked about in the open 2 weeks ago, an overtime loss to Jacksonville State last week, a loss to Tech, or win over Tech on the last play. That's how you convert a third down. Give it to your feature back, in the tackle and the guard slot on the right side. Get the first down yardage.
Yeah, they really got to that second level to block the Mike linebacker, Blake Salter. We kind of saw them before Ward arrived with the football.
Flashed through our screen in that situation.
German had some time, took a hand to the face, complete, digging toward the goal line. That was Bowens, and they call it a touchdown, 21 yards. They're making a 7-point lead for TSU with the extra point coming up.
Now, Bowens found himself open because Travis Ward came into the middle of the field as a receiver after a chip block, drew the attention of the linebackers, Bowen wide open, and that tackle at about the 3, and he was able to stretch it out over the goal line.
First receiving touchdown for Bowens this season. The freshman out of Greenville, South Carolina, now the extra point try for Jameen Godfrey. No problem. 28-20, TSU, big answer after trailing 20-14. And we'll take a break. Murray State, now down 8. We'll have the football when we come back. OBC football on Fox College Sports.
No matter how hard you try, pictures just don't do it justice. The Doritos Locos Tacos, taking tacos where no one thought they'd go.
Biggest lead of the day for TSU, up 28-20 over Murray State. Thanks to this play, a 21-yard touchdown. Michael German, terrific concentration after being hit in the face mask. Got it to Joe Bowen, stretches it out over the goal line for the score. His first receiving touchdown of the year.
You like your quarterbacks to be tough, right? That's the case for German. In the first replay, and then when I saw it live, I thought it was a face mask on him, but I didn't know the severity of it until we looked at it during the break, and that's an outstanding effort, great play, and as you mentioned, great concentration. And Tennessee State back in the lead.
Mofford and Robertson to return for Murray. We've seen a bunch of short kicks in this game. A little more traditional here. Drifting back to the end zone is Robertson, and he'll take a knee for the touchback.
I don't think you'll see Murray State kick to Tennessee State or to Garlington again, that's for sure, after that return.
Well, it's been, as we talked about, a couple big plays in this second half. Garlington's kickoff return of 66 yards, and then TSU really getting out of a huge hole, backed up all the way on the 1 foot line. It was a 52-yard play as German got it to Leonard to the other side of midfield, and they march it down and score and take an 8-point lead. Now Casey Brockman and this Murray State offense trying to come back for the second time today. Nice catch. Got that one to Trotter. First down at the 42.
Yeah, nice back shoulder throw right there. Brockman again in trouble. And again, we need to attribute some of the coverage to the Tennessee State secondary to the fact he's holding on to the football for so long. But Brockman will roll to his left, and nice back shoulder. Watson never had a chance defensively.
Murray can run a bunch of plays. They'll send it outside here. Gain of 5 or 6. Out of the backfield, that was Jamal Berry. Scored a rushing touchdown in the first half from 35 yards.
You know, when we looked at the numbers about Brockman and prepping for this game, you know, we knew the wide receivers were a big part of it. But I've been impressed today with incorporating the running backs into the passing game. The short game, that's a great throw on first down.
Second and 4. Over the middle. They'll have the first down to the 32. That time finding Dwayne Brady.
Passes complete to number 9, Walter Powell.
Check that, Walter Powell, 9 instead of 6. That's his 6th catch of the day. Somewhere around the 90-yard mark. Murray State offense can move the football down the field in a hurry. Brockman looks left, drops it off short. Berry upended at the 26.
Barry's going to come in motion on that play and be the running back. Beside Brockman, he'll chip the defensive end on his way out. That was a designed play to get it to the running back. And again, nice 7 yards on first down.
Second and 3. They go to Berry. Gets to the edge. Knocked out inside the 10. Here come the flags.
Ball Berry on the carry, but we do have flags on the play.
So the question is, how did Berry get to the edge?
Did he have some help?
The answer might be Walter Powell might be your guilty party here with that block.
Good call,
Mr. Bowman. It was Powell. The guilty party, and they'll move it back to just short of the 30. Take another look.
Here's Powell. You're going to see. This is why Berry got to the outside. Got that right arm in just enough.
Redshirt freshman Burnell Brooks out of New Orleans, number 24 for TSU. Second and 7. Pass to Trotter again. Caught at the 20.
Pass is complete.
About 3 yards short.
Devontae Trotter.
Trotter planted his foot and tried to make the turn, and that's when you often see those knee injuries. I'm glad to see him up. I was a little concerned immediately after the catch. Looks like it's going to his hip as well. Keep an eye on him.
Jock back in the slot on the right side here for Murray. Now Brockman looking to the sideline and may have a delay game. Yep, timeout. Tennessee State going to use this first timeout of the second half. We'll take it as well. 28-20, TSU leading Murray. OVC football on Fox College Sports.
When you buy tickets at Ticket City, you're being helped by a real human being. What's behind other ticketing websites? Your Ticket City representative can guide you to the best seats, let you know when your tickets are coming, and show affection to animals. As for those other websites, it's like they're not even trying.
Morehead State University has been ranked one of the top public universities in the South for several consecutive years. Eagle alumni are making their mark. We're business executives, leaders in science, doctors, musicians, athletes, educators. You don't have to look far to see us. We're with you, leading the way to much more. Morehead State University. We're on the map.
In the NCAA Division I Football Championship Subdivision, the game is played with perseverance, integrity, passion, character, and sportsmanship as he works to honor the game and respect his teammates, opponents, officials, and fans. Every FCS player grows in his responsibilities as a student athlete and as a member of his campus and community. The NCAA Division I Football Championship Subdivision. Every down, every day.
The primary target is Osama bin Laden.
Capture or kill.
We are comfortable with either outcome.
Six, the raid on Osama bin Laden, a world premiere, Sunday at 8 on the National Geographic Channel.
With Bob Belvin, Kevin Ingram, Stewart Stadium in Murray, Kentucky. Racers trailing Tennessee State 28-20. About a minute and a half to go, third quarter. Casey Brockman, Murray State offense, trying to claw back after leading 20-14 earlier in this quarter. TSU, a couple scores.
That run is good enough for another racer.
Move the chains for the Racers.
First and 10, Murray State on the Tennessee State 18-yard line.
Ball at the 18. Fast-paced offense for Murray. Peyton Award candidate, Casey Brocklin. Amazing run of games for him this season. Shoots it outside, got it to Brady. And tackled it around the 8-yard line, and maybe another first down should be for Murray. Set up first and goal for the Racers. Talk about the numbers for Casey Brockman against UT Martin, an OVC record, 35 completions and 8 touchdowns, 6 straight games over 300 yards, and 4 at least 400 yards.
Talk about coming out on fire. He hit his first 15 passes against Austin Peay.
That's amazing. Here's Barry.
They were shell-shocked.
Jamal Barry on the carry.
We'll push it down to the 6-yard line for Murray.
Andrew Taylor on the tackle.
As we're under a minute to play here in the third. Barry again. Falls at the 5. I think Wilson Robinson, the linebacker, maybe a little shaken up there for TSU at the end of that play.
Gain of 1 on the play. Bring up 3rd and goal from the 5.
Call. TSU didn't wrap up. Barry has his 2nd TD of the day.
And that's a nice run. I don't want to go to book as a short touchdown run, but a nice effort, nice run done by Barry. As you mentioned, to shake those tackles because, you know, the defense compacts just like the offense does at that point in the field. So a big touchdown there for Murray State, and they're right back. So back and forth we go.
He had a 35-yard run in the first half, now a 5-yard carry, and Murray will go for 2. Can tie the ball game if it works. Brockman, fake left, bottled up, into the end zone, got the 2.
2-point conversion.
Watkins with the reception, and we're tied at 28. But a flag on the play.
Well, we do have a flag on the play.
You know, nonetheless, this does go against Murray State. What great improvisation. Again, keeping the play alive.
Well, I have to try it again.
That was the overloaded formation, and the play was designed to throw the pass to the right side. And Brockman went there, and it was well defensed by Tennessee State, so then he come back to his left, the oncoming rush, and found the receiver in the end zone. The 2, but it goes by the wayside. So remember, Murray State is throwing an interception in their end zone in the opening drive of the game in the red zone, and now they'll come away with a point after attempt, a 1-point point after attempt here instead of the 2 that they tried.
Still so much time left that I'm always okay with not chasing the point. You absolutely have to. 27 seconds to play in the third. Murray trying to make it a 1-point game, and Ben's able to do just that.
Score, Tennessee State
28-27, with 27 ticks left in the third. And we'll take a break. TSU gets the football in a moment, leading only by a point. OVC football, Fox College Sports. Point game, Tennessee State 28, Murray State 27, as we bring you Fox College Sports presentation of OVC football with Bob Belvin, Kevin Ingram. It's been a feature part of game day here in Murray for a long time. Out here early with the horse trailer. Bob brought a bucket of oats. Didn't get a chance to use them, though.
Let me tell you something. If they could get that horse in the nearby CSFB Center, they would do it as well. That's as much of the tradition of Murray State as it,
Isn't Isaiah Cannon enough?
A lot of teams in the conference will say yes. Add Ed Daniel to that mix as well.
Well, they were picked to finish first in their division. It'll be divisional play in basketball this year. Should be some fun matchups. Not only Murray State, Tennessee State excellent in basketball, and they had some great matchups last year on the hardwood. Belmont now part of the league, picked to finish first in the East Division. Football action on a Saturday afternoon, as nice as it gets here. Western part of the Commonwealth, Garlington. Flag on the play as he got it to the 19.
Tennessee State with some poor starting field position here, not what they're used to when Garlington returns the kickoff. We'll wait on the infraction, but certainly appears it'll be against Tennessee State.
Number 26.
Well, if there's a bugaboo for a team that's 8-1 on the season, I think penalties, Rod Reed will tell you, have been it. Close to 90 yards per game.
First and 10, Tennessee State from their own 6-yard line.
Coming in today, have been penalized 93 times for 804 yards.
One of the things about this game, it's been very tight in the last few years, and so far through nearly the first three quarters, it's played out just that way. So get ready. This fourth quarter should be a very exciting 15 minutes of football.
Yeah, you're right, Bob. A lot of the games have been closed, but not so much last year. And I think Tennessee State remembers that. And certainly just an important conference game, all that aside, as we get a run on first down for Germany. TSU won last year 58-27. The game that saw Casey Brockman throw for 607 touchdowns and also caught one.
Gain of 4 yards on the play. Bring up second down and six.
Second and six here as we reach the conclusion of the third period of football. 1-point game, TSU 28, Murray State 27. Fourth quarter coming up. OVC football on Fox College Sports. Fourth quarter begins here in Murray, Kentucky, Stewart Stadium. Kevin Ingram, Bob Belvin, glad to have you with us. The track, as they call it. Seen some offense today. TSU has the football as we have 15 minutes to play. They lead by one. Tennessee State was down 20-14 after a field goal early in the third. Then German on a 1 yard run and a pass play for a score. Completion this time to AC Leonard. Incomplete.
German pass is out of bounds and incomplete.
Leonard trying to tiptoe along the sideline right there. I tell you what. That is indeed an NFL prospect, the way he blocks, and we have talked a lot about that so far in the game. Take a look at Leonard, trying to tiptoe down the sideline here and get the catch.
Went up and got it just out of bounds.
Only chance he had was with the first foot, and it was half in the white and half on the field.
Third and six for the Tigers. Couple receivers to the right side, through the hands of Leonard, incomplete. TSU will have to punt to start the fourth.
Good pressure then by Murray State. First time I've seen what amounted to an all-out blitz right there. And you see Russ Ehrenfeld, the offensive line coach for Tennessee State, coming into the picture there. Now he's out of it, but he was a little disappointed that his offensive line did not pick that up. It came from the middle. German had to get rid of it very quickly.
Davis and Powell, they're standing at their 47. Godfrey will punt. TSU involved in another close game. It was a 1-point win on the last play of the game last week. Headed toward a tight finish here today. Powell on the return.
Walter Powell on the return.
The way Murray's offense operates. Starting field position, maybe not a huge deal, but you're going to be in great shape here at the 39.
Now you'll take it when you can get it. And I no doubt feel Chris Hatcher is pleased with where they're going to start this possession. Again, Casey Brockman, numbers not quite there today. 227 yards through three quarters, 21-30. He's got it done rushing the ball a couple of times, converting on a fourth and two thirds. Keep drives alive.
Out of the gun as they go empty. Completion to Powell. Shakes free and inside the 20. First down for Murray State. You know, work inside the red zone. Talk about close games. These Murray teams suffered three conference losses by a total of 11 points. Coach Hatcher saying that last week in that 38-35 loss at Jacksonville State, disappointed in the result, but not with the way his team played. And a shot here today against a team that's been the conference's best throughout the season. Pressure on Bachman. Complete. Digging toward the goal line. Did he get in? That was Davis. Just short at the one.
I continue to be amazed at how strong Casey Brockman is in terms of staying in the pocket under pressure. Never gets rattled.
First and goal at the one. Brockman to the left and scores. Touchdown, Murray State.
Back and forth we go. So now the question, do you go for two in this situation if you're Murray State? There's a little discussion going on. Chris Hatcher's come all the way out to the numbers. And he wants the ball taken to the left hash mark.
Fourth quarter, couldn't start a whole lot better for Murray State. The defense got off the field, forced to punt. Now Brockman on a 1 yard carry. They'll go for two. So give him a 7-point lead. Brockman got it.
2-point conversion.
This one's going to count. Had one wiped off by a penalty when Watkins with the reception. 35-28 Racers.
Back to the score. Here's why we got the first six, or how we got the first six on the board. Brockman with the carry, just nothing fancy left tackle. You like to see the quarterback kind of get rewarded with a touchdown of his own.
7-point lead for the Racers. OVC football on Fox College Sports.
Hey, it's Vince Offa here with my new product called the Sticky. You're going to clean your home in a quickie when you use your Sticky. Now, here's the deal. It's a reusable lint roller and more.
For furniture, food particles in the cabinets, whiskers on the bathroom sink, no more dragging heavy vacuums. Grab debris on the stairs. Keep kids from tracking sand at the beach. And even use it in the car. And ladies, you always wanted to stick it to your husband. Now you can. Works on all fabrics, from wool to velvet. Problem with your kitty hairs? Pick up cat hairs from clothes. Or use Sticky on the leftover dog hairs on the sofa. Or even Sticky your pets before they shed.
It's made of a special silicone. So, with a little water, the dirt comes right off. It's slippery when wet, Sticky when dry. Check this out.
With the Sticky, you don't have to leave your house to save a tree. Stop wasting $100 a year on paper lint rollers.
And for those unwanted guests.
Hey, Vince!
When you order the Sticky, you get the little Sticky. Great for on the go. Get rid of dandruff for that first date, or lint for that important business meeting. Grab itchy hairs at the salon. Use Sticky anytime, any place, and on anyone.
Sticky makes you look your best, even for those unforgettable moments.
And when you call, be sure to ask about the deluxe big Sticky. An extra large Sticky for those extra large cleaning jobs and those hard to reach areas.
So you get the Sticky and the little Sticky for $10. But if you call now, you'll get a second set free. Just pay for processing. That's four for $10. Here's how to order.
Call 1-800-581-6094. That's 1-800-581-6094. When you call, be sure to ask about the big Sticky. Call 1-800-581-6094. Call now and receive a second bonus set. That's four Stickies for just $10. Call 1-800-581-6094. That's 1-800-581-6094. Call now.
Ohio Valley Conference fans can go to ovcsports.com for the latest news, weekly releases, and up-to-date stats for all around the Ohio Valley Conference. Go to ovcsports.com, get detailed info on all 17 championships and the league's annual award winners. ovcsports.com, one-stop shopping for all things OVC. Entertaining football game today here in Murray, 35-28. The Racers have regained the lead. Back-to-back touchdowns after TSU had gone in front 28-20. 5 yard run by Barry, a 1 yard run by Brockman. Barry scored two touchdowns today. Brockman has passed for one and rushed for one.
Stevenson on the return.
Now return by Stevenson for TSU, and we'll have it to the 24. With 14:05 to play, you see the time.
Tackle made by number 23, Darian Skinner. It'll be first and 10, Tennessee State. On their own
TSU trying to
line.
Stay atop the standings in the OVC, a 4-1 record coming in, tied with UT Martin and Eastern Illinois. Walter Powell, another big day for this Murray State offense. 7 catches for 115 and a touchdown. That's 5 straight over 100 yards.
And he's found a way to get open. On average, I think the TSU defense against him in the secondary has been pretty solid, but he manages to either come back to the ball when Brockman is in trouble or just find ways to get open.
Here's Travis Ward. When in doubt, go to that man.
Travis
He'll have
Ward,
a first down at the 36.
I think the MO for Tennessee State right here, Kevin, is a long, sustained drive. No need to panic. You're down a touchdown with 13 minutes to go. And you've got Travis Ward able to run the football. And you've got German to find A.C. Leonard when things get tight. I like to see TSU just run the football here.
34th carry of the day for Ward. Getting close to 100 carry. Yards.
Tackle on the play by number 51, Kevin Wells.
99 on 34 carries after that. 2-yard run to open the scoring back in the first quarter.
As long as it's only been 12 this afternoon, and I think the first time we saw these two teams play, or rather, we saw Tennessee State play against Jacksonville State, he had a couple 30-yarders, 30-plus in that mix. That's not been the case. So Murray State's kind of kept him in check for the most part this afternoon.
Also saw Tim Broughton in that game a couple weeks ago, and he hasn't carried the football today. That's a completion to Leonard, and we'll scamper out near midfield.
So Murray State coming with a blitz right then.
Out of bounds on the near sideline.
6 catch of the day for Leonard. He's over 100 yards. Move the chains for TSU.
Watch your pressure come up the middle. It's German. There it is right there. Leonard with a catch, breaks one tackle, and gets it near midfield.
German stood in there, threw the football, took the contact at the end. First and 10 at midfield. Down a score, TSU. Here's Ward. To the 44.
Travis Ward on the carry. Tackle made by number 9.
Murray State back and forth. Now they're going to come with more linebackers. Give up on the DB, so to speak, and go with a heavier package to try and combat the run here against Tennessee State.
Zach Ross made that stop. Transfer from Eastern Arizona College. Out of Atlanta originally, a redshirt junior. Murray, here comes the pressure, and pass away again for another completion. And that's Leonard one more time. First down at the 35.
How frustrating must it be to pretty much feel like that combination is going to happen? Now watch German here. Leonard just coming. He's tight to the right. This comes across right at the linebacker space with the catch, the stiff arm, and another first down.
Rusher basically untouched right up the middle. High formation for TSU. They'll run with Ward behind Fred.
Travis Ward on the
won't get much.
Yeah, back to your point on the Leonard reception, just to play a go and the pressure up the middle. What I talked about watching Murray State in their adjustments. Now they're going to bring some more beef in on the offensive line. You see TSU with a lot of substitutions coming in and out right now. So second and long appears to be a passing down. That's kind of what Murray State is counting on right now, and they may indeed come with some type of blitz.
Second and 8. Ward the single setback this time. Two tight end formation. 6-man front for Murray. German short drop. And that was an interception. Tip ball. And held on to by Julian Whitehead.
Well, we featured him in the academic feature a little while ago out of Georgia. And that time, just an outstanding play. Devin Wilson just flat out didn't catch the football, but Julian Whitehead did. Watch this. Here's the isolation now on Wilson coming down. Just did extend his arms and caught it off the shoulder pads, and Whitehead right there for the INT.
Second pick of the year for Whitehead. last thing you needed if you're TSU, trailing by seven. And Murray will get the ball with just over 11 minutes remaining.
Biggest turnover of the afternoon so far, and it's costly for Tennessee State.
They turned it over toward the end of the first half. Didn't really cost him anything. We've seen this play three times now today, and it's worked, it seems like, all three. That'll be a first down to the 44. It was Barry carrying the football.
Now Barry nearing 100 yards, toting the pigskin this afternoon. Nice compliment again to Brockman. Back to the tempo. This is what Murray State, regardless of where you are on the clock and even where they are in the game, whether leading or trailing, they like this tempo.
They lead 35-28. A rolling catch made that time by Trotter. Just one Florida player after another in this game. You talk about Barry from Miami and Dwayne Brady from St. Augustine. Javonte Trotter from St. Petersburg. Second and seven here for the Racers. Leading by a score and just short of midfield. Delayed handoff, Brockman gives to Barry. He'll move the chains, stay on his feet. 15, 10, and down at the five. Extra effort by Barry. He goes over 100 yards rushing, and he has been huge for the Racers today.
Almost seems like he's emerged here in the second half. Play action, gonna hand it to Barry, and the rest is his. Breaks one tackle, two tackles. Defender runs by him. Now he's open, just cannot quite get it into the end zone.
TD saving stop by Daniel Fitzpatrick. First and goal at the five for Murray State. Pair of wideouts each way for Casey Brockman. As Brady next to him. Looks toward the end zone underneath. Touchdown to Trotter. A six for number seven. Fourth receiving touchdown of the season for Javonte Trotter.
Five-yard touchdown pass to number seven, Javonte Trotter.
And Murray State adding on to its lead, now 41-28.
And what can you say about Brockman? Again, remaining in the pocket. And we haven't talked a lot about the offensive line, but they have given him tremendous time to throw the football this afternoon.
Extra point coming up. Trying to make it a 14-point lead.
And it's good.
42-28. We'll take a look at the scoring play going out. TSU in trouble. Down two scores. OVC football on Fox College Sports.
A few weeks ago, someone told the remote small town of Bethel, Alaska, they were getting a Taco Bell. But they were crushed to find out it was only a hoax. Well, it's time somebody delivered some good news. Along with 10,000 Doritos Locos Tacos.
Who wants Taco Bell?
The Doritos Locos Tacos, taking tacos where they've never been before.
When you buy tickets at Ticket City, you're being helped by a real human being. What's behind other ticketing websites? Your Ticket City representative can guide you to the best seats. Let you know when your tickets are coming, and show affection to animals. As for those other websites, it's like they're not even trying.
A life of adventure.
Let me take off for the Racers.
Biggest lead of the day for Murray State, 42-28 over Tennessee State. Tigers with 9:33. Left to try to stay in first place in the OVC standings.
Eastern Illinois is watching this game with great interest. We have it next week against Southeast Missouri. And, of course, Eastern Illinois, one of those teams tied at the top of the conference with Tennessee State.
Garlington and Stevenson back to return. Garlington setting up a TSU score with a 66-yard return back in the third quarter. Bob, you pointed it out, Murray State able to get some good pressure on Michael German. That's made a big difference as we've gotten into this fourth quarter here.
I think some of it's been the looks personnel-wise. They bought in a little bit of beef. You know, I commented in that last possession where they were leaning more toward putting more pressure or finding a way to put more pressure on Michael German, and that means he doesn't have time to find number one. That would be A.C. Coleman.
Bent needed a little help.
Stevenson
to return from the 10. He puts together a nice return to about the 40-yard line before he's dragged down. Put it at the 41 right, for TSU.
You know, Murray's base defense is a 4-3, but and like you'll see a lot of times in game, you've seen some adjustments that these coordinators will make, and I think this is a case in point with what Murray State has done defensively. Take a look at Stevenson. Nice return here. Thought by the way he spun, it was a face mask, a horse collar, kind of close right there. But not called.
So a 34-yard return. And here's Michael German, the TSU offense. Dropped off short, first down. Went to Ward with a short pass.
German pass completion number two, Travis Ward.
Inside Murray State territory, 44-yard line of the Racers.
See, this is where Ward is a double threat. He could catch the football out of the backfield, and you can include him in their route immediately instead of having him chip the defensive lineman or the linebacker in this case. So what do you do if you think your opponent is sensing they're trying to shut down the run? Find other ways to get Ward the football.
Trailing by two scores, German, well protected, nice catch. Complete or not, nope, incomplete. Garlington couldn't hang on.
And that's the best result for Tennessee State right then, because he laid the ball on the turf, and at first glimpse it looked like he might have had a catch. Take a look at Garlington coming across. Ball is high, ooh, thought he bought it down. Is that the made the old football play there, Coach?
Yeah, you talk about making a football move. He gathered it back in. They call it incomplete. Second and 10 at the 44. Two wides each way. German, before he can fall, sends it downfield. Leonard can't haul it in.
German's pass intended for number one.
Thought AC might make that play. We've seen him make a bunch of catches today. He's come up with 7 balls for 115.
Looking into the sun and running against the wind. Those are the two factors that were involved in that one. And of course, German had to get it away quickly. Got that pressure, back to that pressure we talked about. So here's a big third down of the football game. Just under 9 to play. You're down 2 touchdowns. Yes, you're in your opponent's end of the field, but you need a big play here. And you also need to have something in your back pocket for fourth down in this situation.
Yayavi on the coverage. San Diego. Third and 10. Ward stopped for a loss. This Murray State defense certainly toughening up.
And Julia Whitehead with another play. Remember, he had the interception in the last possession. Again, wanting to get the ball to Ward. He's going to come out of the backfield to your right, but Whitehead going to sense this one all the way. Great open field tackle. See, there's no one in the screen right then. Whitehead doesn't make that play, it's a first down.
Godfrey will come on to punt. Murray with two return men back at the 10. Neither will get a chance. This will roll out at the 25.
Godfrey's kick is out of bounds at about the
7:53 remaining. Murray leading by 14. Racers will have the football again.
I don't know if this is counterproductive to what you want to do or in your DNA as far as this hatch attack offense goes here for Murray State, named after their head coach, Chris Hatcher. But you really want to run some clock here in this situation. You know, perfect world, you have a long, sustained drive, you eat a lot of clock, and you may score on top of that, which could probably seal this game. So Murray State really wants to have one of those drives right now.
They get it off to a good start with a catch by Powell. That's his 8th reception of the day. Murray starting this series with 484 yards of total offense.
Nick Thrasher a little slow to get up. See, leading tackler for Tennessee State, they whistled it dead, so they're going to make him leave the game. He's one of those academic performers you highlighted just a moment ago as well.
Coming into this game with 90 tackles, 7.5 tackles for loss, a sack, had 9 stops a week ago, sophomore out of Morrow, Georgia. Heavy on underclassmen, this TSU defense. No seniors, 6 sophomores among the starting 11. Here's that play again. TSU hasn't been able to find a way to stop it. It's Brady, all the way inside Tennessee State territory, or maybe not, maybe just short of midfield.
Well, when you throw the football so well like Murray State does, you can use this play 4 times already in the course of the game. We're midway through the fourth quarter, and each and every time, to my recollection, Kevin, it's been very successful.
Now the officials will stop play.
The flag on the far side of the field right in front of the TSU bench. It's so far out, it's out of our screen. As a sideline warning, perhaps.
Substitution infraction on the defense. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
Back to your point, TSU being one of the most penalized teams in this conference. Just under 90 a game.
That'll make it first and 5 here for Murray after that 5-yard walk-off. Bob, I think you're right. Another score here for Murray might put the Racers in good shape to win this thing. The outside tip ball coming back to try to make the play. It was Davis, but it's incomplete.
Rockman's pass intended for number 31, Jeremy Harness.
Check that was Harness instead of Davis.
And Rashad Knight is going to just deflect it here. Going to reach his left arm out. And then for Murray, almost a catch, but just off the turf. Tried to sell it for the INT. Had some help from the sideline.
Rockman, short pass for Brady. Shut down at midfield.
Pass is complete to number 6, Dwayne Brady.
See big Samquan Evans getting outside there, number 93 for TSU.
Bring up third down and 8.
Mentioned Rashad Knight, number 4.
And look for Powell in this situation on the receiving end. And of course, Trotter's coming into the picture here in the third quarter. That's a double threat that TSU must defense against. Big third down here for Murray State, actually, Kevin. I really feel like they want to convert here, and they're intentionally running that clock down as much as they can.
Got 6.5 to go. You see the time. 3rd and 8 for Casey Brockman. He pumped. Looked like he might go long. Try to find Brady in the middle of the field. Incomplete. Make that Powell.
Rockman's pass intended for number 9, Walter Powell, is incomplete. That'll bring up 4th down.
So Murray State will be punting with the wind to their back. I really need to get a good boomer out here and pin Tennessee State again.
I haven't seen Stephen Mix a whole lot today. Boy, maybe a second or third punt of the afternoon. 6:16 to go. TSU running short on time. For Murray State, you know, at least you worked a little time off the clock there. Fair catch requested and made at the 8.
Fair catch.
Garlington hauls it in.
On their own 8-yard line.
TSU will bring on the offense down 42-28. It's turned out to be just a lovely day here in Murray, Kentucky. We had about all the cold weather we could handle last week when we were up in Richmond, but much nicer today.
For the last Saturday in October, right?
Yeah, Saturday in November, not so bad.
So make sure you're not in an alternating jinx, right? which would mean what, Kevin?
No telling what might happen up in Charleston, Illinois.
That's
next week.
What I'm concerned about. I've been warned about that. So we'll take this road show westernmost point in the Ohio Valley Conference,
in football,
but it's
anyway.
Eastern Illinois.
Yep.
I guess, is it west of Edwardsville?
Edwardsville would be over by St. Louis. A little over 6 minutes left. Travis Ward carries to the 11 for Tennessee State. 37th rush attempt of the day.
Might be too little too late, though, Kevin. I really, you know, obviously the score dictates that Tennessee State needs to try and air it out right here, and no longer does a run to Travis Ward become a decoy of sorts.
Well, especially at your own 8-yard line. German will throw. Incomplete through the hands of Bowens.
Intended for number 81, Joe Bowens.
Yeah, credit Murray State here in the second half in particular, just notching up that rush defensively just a little bit, and it's really given German some problems here in the third and into the fourth quarter. And now they're faced with a third down conversion they must convert on, obviously to keep the drive alive, but also they're in terrible field position to try and fight against a 14-point deficit.
Boy, 9 of 16 on the day. I say only, that's not too bad. 56% on third down for TSU. German with time. Things start to break down, and he'll be sacked at the 2.
Quarterback sacked by the Aces. Number 92, Jeremy Blackett.
Going to give that one to coverage right then, because you can see every white shirt on the field is covered up by a blue and gold shirt.
Well, Jeremy Blackett called his name a few times today, number 92.
And you just like a defensive lineman, it continues to keep the motor running into the fourth quarter. German fighting for his life, trying to keep the drive alive, and Brackett bearing down on him. Again, the pressure will come up the middle, and German will run back into it.
Tigers, number 43, Jamin Godfrey.
Turned his back, but protected the football. He tried to sell a fumble there with Murray State, but not the case. Now, Godfrey has no room to work with.
His heels basically on the back line. No rush by Murray. Catch of the 40. Big return. And a touchdown for Powell. That might put the icing on the cake. Although we do have a flag at the 8-yard line. Walter Powell had a punt return for a score earlier this season. Don't know if this one's going to count, though.
Had a touchdown called back earlier as well, so kind of a bad luck day. In the scheme of things, he's got every right to be very frustrated. He's had a touchdown, catch called back. He's had a punt return for a touchdown called back. Eventually, he'll have the football first and 10 at the 17. Let's take a look at Powell. To the bottom right of your screen. He's going to come back across here and make the play. Reaches out right there at the 11-yard line and makes the hold right there. Jamie Godfrey, after punting the ball, trying to make the tackle, and he was the one that was held.
And that's one that I, you know, if you let it go, I think he scores anyway.
Punter's not going to make the tackle. What's he thinking, right?
Well, a start inside the red zone here for Murray State. This might actually be better. They'll have a chance to use some clock with 4.5 to go.
Barry on the carry.
Barry will get it to the 8, maybe enough for a first down.
Barry has been very good here in the second half. He's nearing 150 yards.
On a limited number of carries, really. Look at his day. 12 for 136 before that one, and a couple touchdowns.
And you match that average against Travis Ward of Tennessee State, who's had to carry 37 times in the game and does not have the yardage that Barry has.
Now 13 for 147 with 4 minutes left and a 42-28 lead. Looking for room on the outside, Barry pounds it down inside the 5. Murray's player signaling touchdown, official signaling down at the 1.
Barry on his back was holding the ball over the goal line. He was trying to sell it. He's looking to the sidelines saying, keep me in, coach, and call my number. He'll bounce out to the left side. Look at that line, pushing forward. Broke a tackle from the backside pursuit, and then the rest of it's all Barry.
Now Casey Brockman from the shotgun with 3:20 to play, trying to put this one out of reach for Murray State. Use as much time as they can before the snap is made. Barry, he's in there this time. 1 yard carry, 48-28. Lead reaches 20 with the extra point coming up for Murray.
How impressive has Murray State been in the second half, Kevin?
hey, have really come out of the locker room, made the necessary adjustments in the locker room. You could see a little bit of it toward the end of the second quarter, but they have been dominant here in the second half.
Third TD of the day for Jamal Berry. Scoring drive set up by a good punt return. PAT is true. 49-28 is the score. Murray State comfortably in front. As we head down the stretch, another look. OBC football on Fox College Sports. The score of Murray State leading Tennessee State with 3:05 to play. Some of the fans here in Murray, Kentucky, enjoying just a beautiful afternoon for college football on Fox College Sports. Bringing you the OVC Game of the Week with Bob Belvin. I'm Kevin Ingram. Glad to have you along. Coming up next week, we'll be in Charleston, Illinois, and then at Clarksville to finish up the season. Home game for Bob a couple weeks down the road.
The semi-home game for the Nashville native.
There you go.
A resident, I should say, not native.
Stevenson on the return.
Stevenson from the 14 for TSU, needing three scores in a hurry.
So, Kevin, what do these four numbers have in common? 52, 49, 35, and 59.
I think they're all point totals for Murray State the last 4 weeks.
185 points. Did my math wrong there? Got to check. 185 points in the last four games.
Trying to break a two-game losing streak. They had lost 66-59 against UT Martin and 38-35 at Jacksonville State last week, but looking good to get back to 500 in conference play, and this would really be a costly defeat for TSU. Rod Reed's team coming in with a 4-1 record. And will finish a stretch of 10 games in 10 weeks with only their second loss of the season, barring a big comeback. Completion to the Murray State side of midfield.
Pass is complete. Number 89,
they got it that time to Andrew Bather. First time we called his name today from Laverne.
On the Murray State 47-yard line.
Been some good defense by Murray in addition to the offense that you would expect out of the Racers. Garlington with the catch.
Number 15, Weldon Garlington.
Mark his progress to the 42.
Totally agree with you on that observation. Murray State defensively has been impressive. Now keep in mind, we talked about some staggering numbers that in the Racers have scored offensively. But they've also lost games this season in which they've given up 50 points, 42 points, or 69 to Florida State. That's understandable in that case. And also, they gave up 66 on homecoming to Tennessee Martin. So they've tightened up defensively here, especially in the second half, and that's been the difference in this football game.
Now a little looser on the coverage. TSU moving the football. Wilson with the catch. First down at the 20 for the Tigers. We hit 2 minutes to play. Michael German tosses over the middle, incomplete. Out of the reach of Bowens, who caught a touchdown earlier.
For number 81, Joe Bowens is incomplete.
Bowens has been kind of quiet so far this game for Tennessee State. And Leonard, certainly the target of German through the first three quarters, and Bowens a little bit here in the fourth. But Tennessee State, you know, like we mentioned, just been kind of teetering. They haven't played well the last 3 to 4 weeks, Kevin. And this afternoon, okay for a half, but certainly here in the second half has not been up to par.
Well, really, the fourth quarter has been the rough one for TSU today. German will slide down at the 7.
Michael German on the carry.
Defender lost the hat for Murray State. That was Tyler Evans.
He's got a few words for the offensive lineman that he finds responsible for it. And, of course, according to the new rules, he must leave the game.
Well, you think back, you know, early in the third quarter, it was 20-14 Murray, but then a couple scores from TSU. We saw a TD catch by Bowens and a 5-yard, or after a TD run by German. TSU led 28-20, but been all Murray since then. German to the end zone. Wilson can't haul it in. Would have been a touchdown. The minute 28.
And that's the same play that they had a touchdown on earlier, when he found Garlington back in the first half, had a run pass option and had Leonard, the tight end, both blocking, and he could have rubbed off the defender and gone to the pylon, but instead an incomplete pass. Now second and goal, very manageable for German and Tennessee State, but again, they have been very inept here in the second half.
Two touchdown runs by Barry. Brockman with a TD run and a pass to Trotter for a score. Now German trying to get TSU in the end zone. Incomplete, looking for James. No flag. Brings up third and goal with 1:24 to play.
Eastern Illinois is yet to kick off this afternoon. Checking a couple scores from the conference. Of course, Austin Peay leading Culver Stockton, and a couple games later on this afternoon. This is the earliest game for television purposes, but a lot of folks around the conference certainly watching this one, because everyone coming into today had their eyes on Tennessee State. They're come from behind victory on the last play of the game last week against Tennessee Tech, just staying alive near the top of the standings.
Lob toward the corner. Leonard has it poked away. Good coverage by Kadarius Sanders.
And Sanders goes to that highest point. You hear coaches talk about a lot. So Sanders out jumps Leonard in this case, and just enough to bat it away. That's exactly what you want to do. You don't want a big guy like Leonard to have a batted ball around him that he could go up and get right at the highest point. Sanders knocks it away. Nice defense then.
South Carolina transfer.
So what do you got in your bag of chips for fourth down, Coach?
Try to go back to Leonard again, I guess. Ball at the 8, fourth and goal, minute 20. TSU trying to stay alive on this fourth down play. German, catch, and a stop.
Corey Addison.
Catch was made by Bather. Addison got the stop. Murray State will take over on downs.
And that really puts an exclamation point on the defensive effort here in the second half by Murray State. Take a look at this. German's going to roll to his right. Watch Addison. Denying the end zone. Outstanding.
Now with a minute 15 left, Murray State will be able to run out the clock.
Problem is they can't take a knee in this situation.
Yeah, that's a good point. TSU with three timeouts, so they elect to use them, but. We look at all the different folks who've caught passes today, from Casey Brockman, Powell and Trotter, Barry and Brady, Watkins, Morrow, Robertson, Davis, Griffin, and Harness. He has spread the love, and Murray State's going to get out of here with the victory this afternoon. It'll be only the second defeat for TSU, but a costly win in conference play. 373 per game. Look at the passing stats today. 271, a lot more balanced than maybe normally for Murray. 251 on the ground, 271 through the air. 104 rushing yards in this fourth quarter.
And tip your hat to Barry and Brady for toting the football for Murray State and balancing it out.
They'll have a first down on the second and one. Got the whistle finally blows.
Yeah, got Casey Brockman a curtain call there as well.
Hmm. 31 seconds left. They'll stop the clock to move the chains. TSU will slip to 4-2 in conference play. UT Martin, Eastern Illinois, as we talked about, both at 4-1 as well entering today's play. Martin hosting Jacksonville State, Eastern Illinois at Tennessee Tech. Katie Humphreys on at quarterback. Have a first down of his own to the 37.
Katie Humphreys on the carry.
10 seconds left.
That gain is good enough for another racer. First and 10, Murray State on their own 36-yard line.
About the only excitement left for the Tennessee State fans that have made the trip. A performance by the band of Aristocats in the post game. And Murray State, a nice win at home this afternoon as you see Chris Hatcher making his way across the field.
Yeah, Chris Hatcher's group, 49-28. Beautiful day for football. The sun shining bright on Murray as they beat TSU by 21 with a huge fourth quarter, outscoring the Tigers 22-0 in the final period of football. Take a break. Back to wrap it up in just a moment from Murray, OVC football on Fox College Sports.
How hard you try, pictures just don't do it justice. The Doritos Locos Tacos, taking tacos where no one thought they'd.
29 unanswered points by Murray State. They beat Tennessee State 49-28. Murray gets back to 500 at 3-3 in Ohio Valley Conference play. TSU with a costly second defeat with four victories in the OVC, and we'll see how the rest of the day plays out. They came in part of a three-way tie for first place. Kevin Ingram with Bob Belvin, and get a look at some of the scoring plays. And Murray State down the stretch, 22 points in the fourth quarter. A couple of touchdown runs for Jamal Berry. Casey Brockman on the day, 27 of 38, 271. A couple touchdowns. Also ran for one, six carries for 19 yards. Berry, 16 for 163 and three TDs. Bob, that'll get it done.
Very impressive, the balance. And coming into the game, if you'd have told me Casey Brockman would have only thrown for 271 yards, I would have said, well, that's another day at the office, but I'm not so sure that Murray State would win with that kind of effort. Well, they did. And being able to balance out, run the football, and of course, when you need to, the old passing game is there. And Trotter, Berry, Powell, all influential this afternoon in Murray State's win.
Walter Powell, 8 catches for 117 and a score. A.C. Leonard, 7 for 115 for TSU. Travis Ward ran it 37 times for 111. Michael German, 273, 2 touchdowns and an interception. So we'll say so long from Murray. We'll be in Charleston, Illinois next week. For Bob Belvin, our entire Fox College Sports crew, Kevin Ingram saying so long from Murray, Kentucky. 49-28 is the final as the Racers beat the Tigers. Murray State now 3-3 in the OVC, 4-5 overall. TSU 8-2 and 4-2 as they head to an off week. We'll see you next time. OVC football on Fox College Sports.